इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ प्रसव प्रांजपे जी, हमारे सबके बहुत ही माननीय प्रोफेसर एस आर भट्ट जी, श्री तरुण विजय जी, इस संगोष्ठी में जो अब तक शामिल हमारे बहुत ही डिस्टिंग्विश पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैं, इंक्लूडिंग द फेलोज ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट एंड ऑल्सो द पार्टिसिपेंट्स ऑफ इंडिया एंड ऑल्सो अब्रॉड. And therefore, I was thinking whether this, the third National Integration Conference is really an international conference rather than a national conference. We have been deliberating for the last 2 days on various dimensions of Swaraj in ideas, or what we have termed as Vaicharik, Swaraj. और हम इस बात पर असल में हमारे मन में आया था कि जब हम आत्मनिर्भर भारत की बात करते हैं तो आत्मनिर्भर भारत केवल एक आर्थिक कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं है. आत्मनिर्भरता केवल एक आर्थिक अवधारणा नहीं है, बट इट इज़ ए कल्चरल, सोशल एंड अदर काइंड ऑफ डायमेंशंस दैट आर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन दिस, एंड ऑल्सो द इंटेलेक्चुअल आत्मनिर्भरता. जब तक इंटेलेक्चुअल आत्मनिर्भरता का मतलब ये नहीं है कि हम किसी से कुछ सीखेंगे नहीं, बट एट द सेम टाइम हम अपने को भी नहीं छुपाएंगे, एंड वट एवर वी कैन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू द वेलबींग ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया एंड ऑल्सो पीपल अक्रॉस द ग्लोब, आई थिंक दिस टाइम दैट वी मस्ट थिंक इंडिपेंडेंटली एंड एट द सेम टाइम मस्ट डेवलप अवर ओन मॉडल्स of development, which we have been believing as a holistic kind of approach to development rather than fragmented approach to development. So from fragmentation to unification to integration, that is what the idea behind Vaicharik Swaraj was, to the best of my understanding. Today is the last day of a 3-day National Integration Conference, and in fact we are very happy that we have with us today two very important dignitaries as speakers. One is Professor S.R. Bhatt. Professor S.R. Bhatt has been the professor and head of philosophy in the University of Delhi, and he was also the chairman of the Indian Council of Philosophical Research. Presently, he is the chairman of the Indian Philosophical Congress. He is in fact doing a lot of work in this area, and he has recently written a kind of a monograph on Swaraj in ideas. He shall be talking to us on understanding Vaicharik Swaraj or Swaraj in ideas. And in fact, we are very fortunate to have with us Shri Tarun Vijayji. I don't think he needs any introduction. He is a known intellectual figure of the country. He has been talking on various issues off and on, and he is an intellectual activist, in fact. We shall be hearing him today. He shall be talking to us on digital decolonization. It's a very interesting topic, because in the modern age, in the new age media, and other things, we find that there are efforts of various kinds to dominate others. And whether our digital media is in need of any kind of a decolonization, and what does it really mean? I'm not a technical expert in this area, so I have some things. Sir, welcome to you, and we are really happy that you agreed and very kindly consented to give the valedictory address to us all. With us is the inspiration behind this conference, Professor Makarand Pranjpe, who is the director of the institute. In fact, it is he who conceived this idea that let us have a seminar on a conference on Atmanirbhar Bharat, Vaicharik Swaraj ki or. Aur chuke hum har varsh aisa conference national integration की थीम पर कोई ना कोई लेकर के करते हैं. दिस इज द थर्ड नेशनल इंटीग्रेशन कॉन्फ्रेंस इन दैट, एंड इन फैक्ट एट एवरी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम ही हैज बीन नॉट ओनली एक्सटेंडिंग सपोर्ट बट very intellectual, high quality intellectual interventions we have seen on his part. Sir, welcome to you as the chair of the session today. And I now hand over the proceedings to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Rajvi Sharma ji. I hope we can see your face very soon after solving the whatever technical glitch. I welcome Tarun Vijay ji. We are seeing you now on our screen, and I must say you're looking younger and younger with the passing years. We wish you good health and many, 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 many productive years. For those who don't know Shri Tarun Vijay ji, he, I think, has been possibly the longest serving editor of Panchajanya. 12 years, I think, he served. And he is a very, very deeply read and deeply engaged Indian intellectual activist who cares passionately for Mother India, Bhavani Bharati. He was Member of Parliament, and now he's the chairman of the National Monuments Authority. So we welcome you, sir, for the valedictory address. And Professor Bhatt has already been introduced. He's a legend for us, ICPR chair, professor of philosophy at Delhi University. I remember, 20 years ago, there was no one speaking in a certain kind of manner, and he was the only one. And everyone, his own colleagues, used to attack him. I remember those days, but he was extremely strong. And he brought in the Bharatiya point of view in philosophy, and is well known across the country and across the world for his interventions. He's also the chair of the Nalanda Foundation, and his contribution to Indian intellectual thought and traditions is extraordinary, second to none. So welcome all. I just want to add to what Professor Rajvi Sharma ji said. I request you all to send in your papers. This is going to be, I think, an important volume for us at the Institute. Those who have already presented papers in the last 2-3 days, we are going to request them once again to do so. In my opening reflections, I just wanted to mention two things. The first thing is this, that hum log jab स्वराज की बात करते हैं, वैचारिक स्वराज हो, चाहे वो राजनैतिक स्वराज हो, आर्थिक स्वराज हो, हमारी प्रवृत्ति कुछ ऐसी है कि हम राज के बारे में सोचते हैं. हम सब लोगों को ये जो राज है, या तो राज करने का, या राज यानी सत्ता, सत्ता के करीब आने का, सत्ता के द्वारा कुछ काम करवाने का, या सत्ता से जुड़ जाने का, हमारे में एक किस्म की ललक होती है. तो स्वराज ये जो शब्द है, उसमें हमें राज से ज्यादा मतलब है. ये मेरा अनुभव है, मैं गलत भी हो सकता हूँ, लेकिन भारतीय बुद्धिजीवियों में मैंने ये बहुत देखा है. तो कुछ वर्षों पहले मैंने इसके बारे में लेख लिखा था, हाउ डू यू क्लासिफाई इंडियन इंटेलेक्चुअल्स. तो मैंने एक उसके लिए क्लासिफिकेशन दिया था. तो अगर राजवीर जी परमिट्स, आई विल एक्सप्लेन दैट इन 2 मिनट्स. सर
प्लीज.
थैंक यू. सो एक तो है स्टेटिस्ट इंटेलेक्चुअल्स. सो दीज इंटेलेक्चुअल्स डिराइव द पावर, अथॉरिटी, फेम, फॉर्चून फ्रॉम बीइंग क्लोज टू द स्टेट, एंड दे आर कॉन्स्टेंटली लॉबिंग टू बिकम अ पार्ट ऑफ सम स्टेट organization or get state support. And many times you find such intellectuals switching sides. They do not have any great ideological inclination. Main JNU mein aksar mazak udata tha mere doston ka hi, ke lal aur kesri mein antar zyada nahi hai. Aaj aap lal hai, kal kesri ho jayenge, aur ulta bhi sambhav hai, kyunki aapko to satta se matlab hai. और आपके लिए सिर्फ सत्ता ही एक माध्यम है जिससे कोई भी परिवर्तन आ सकता है. इनफैक्ट दैट वाज मार्क्सिस थॉट, यू कैप्चर द स्टेट एंड देन यू चेंज एवरीथिंग. हमारे यहाँ वो नहीं है. आर ऋषिज वर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन कैप्चरिंग पावर. एनीहाउ, सो स्टेटिस्ट इंटेलेक्चुअल्स, देन आई कॉल देम एनजीओ इंटेलेक्चुअल्स. सो दीज आर इंटेलेक्चुअल्स ऑलवेज क्लोज टू सम एनजीओ, एंड यूजुअली द एनजीओ इज अ फ्रंट. they get funded from outside. I won't name names, but some very famous international NGOs, Amnesty, Greenpeace, I can name 10 others, ye sab apna ek intellectual cheez chalate hain. Aur inke paas bhi bahut paise hote hain. Mere ek mitra the, to unhone ek baar mujhe kaha tha ki bhai, tum hamare saath jud jao to hamesha aapke kitab aapke jeb mein ek ticket rahega. Foreign jaane ka ek ticket aapke jeb mein hamesha rahega. So there are NGO intellectuals. Then I call the third group embassy intellectuals. Embassy intellectuals are those who are always associated with either USIS, US Education Foundation, British Council, Max Muller Bhavan, you know, Italian Cultural Center, French India Center, you know, French Center. Aise log hai. तो ये हमेशा उनके दायरे में आते हैं और देन दे गेट प्रमोटेड एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट. सो यू हैव स्टेटस इंटेलेक्चुअल्स, एनजीओ इंटेलेक्चुअल्स, देन यू हैव एज आई सेड एम्बेसी इंटेलेक्चुअल्स. तो ऐसे और भी दो तीन कैटेगरीज है. ग्राम्शी मेड अ पॉइंट अबाउट दिस. ही सेड देयर आर ट्रेडिशनल इंटेलेक्चुअल्स फॉर यूरोप. ट्रेडिशनल इंटेलेक्चुअल्स वर प्रीस्ट्स बेसिकली, यू नो, दोज हु वर एसोसिएटेड विद द चर्च. And to some extent, professors, you know, who were also associated with the church, because all universities in the West started with the church. The church was the foundation of, and religious education was the foundation, including Harvard Divinity School. So traditional intellectuals. Then he said were organic intellectuals, that is working class intellectuals, people who came from the masses, you know, like our own Sant Kavis. They are organic intellectuals. But for Gramsci, which everyone forgets, ultimately the only intellectual who mattered was the party intellectual, because only the party could bring in revolution. But hamare yahan completely alag cheez hoti thi. Yesterday we were talking about the Chandogya Upanishad. So practical Vedant, Swami Vivekananda said, ke, you know, when Shvetaketu came back after 12 years, his father said, have you got Brahma Vidya? Do you know what Brahman is? He said, no. So Brahma Vidya was the highest for us. This is what I'm trying to say. So simply speaking, mera prastav, meri prarthana ye hai ki swaraj mein hum swa pe zyada zor de aur raj pe kam. Agar hum sach maane mein buddhi jeevi hai to, ya buddhi nisht hai to, aur swa ki khoj hi hamare sabhyata ki pehchan hai. स्व की खोज. और जब आपने स्व को हासिल कर लिया तो कोई उपनिवेश आप पे हावी नहीं हो सकता. यू नो, यस्टरडे वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वेरी ब्रीफली अबाउट आनंद मठ एंड द पॉइंट दैट बंकिम इज मेकिंग एट द वेरी स्टार्ट ऑफ दिस रेनेसांस ऑफ इंडिया इन द मॉडर्न पीरियड, विच इज दैट देयर इज ऑलवेज अ पार्ट ऑफ द सेल्फ, द स्व दैट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट, विच रिमेन्स अनकॉलोनाइज्ड. Vivekananda also said that. He said 1857 kyun hua? Ye hua because they started poking us where it mattered the most, our dharma. To upanivesh wale aaye, satta hasil kar li, hamara shoshan bhi shuru kar liya, lekin jab unhone dharma pe akraman kiya to hum logon ko wo bardasht nahi hua. This is, I'm not saying this. Swami ji gives you a reason for 1857, which is different from cartilages and cartridges, greased cartridges, all of those things, which are more superficial. But the deeper thing is that there is a way that this civilization has arranged itself. It has values, it has the purusharthas, whatever. And that way, uska ek tantra hai, to ek pranali hai, to use what Bhatt Sahib said. And we don't want to change that. This is the point. And sometimes I even believe that God Almighty has given us this. कि इस क्षेत्र में, you know, ये सप्त सिंधु कहिए या हिमालय कन्याकुमारी तक कहिए, इस जगह में यही होगा. प्लूरलिज्म होगा, बहुभाषी लोग होंगे और पीपल विल हैव बहुत मत वाले होंगे, सनातनी होंगे, को सनातनी होंगे, एंड मेनी आइडियाज विल फ्लरिश. But the Sanatanism will be given to us to be the custodians of. So ye cheez hum nahi badlenge. This is the way we are, and this is the way we will be. We will remain एकम सत विप्रा बहुधा वदन्ति, ये हम नहीं बदलेंगे, दिस इज समथिंग वी विल नॉट चेंज. एंड देयर आर दीस थिंग्स, कर्म धर्म, दीस आर थिंग्स वी विल नॉट चेंज. सो चाहे कुछ भी हो जाए, सो व्हाट आई एम सिंपली सेइंग इज देयर इज ए पोर्शन ऑफ आवर साइकी दैट इज अनकॉलोनाइज्ड, विल रिमेन अनकॉलोनाइज्ड. एंड व्हेनेवर थिंग्स गेट रियली डिफिकल्ट फॉर अस, इट इज फ्रॉम दैट अनकॉलोनाइज्ड साइकी दैट अ रिस्पॉन्स विल कम. We saw it over and over again in our history when we had the worst of the Mughal times, Aurangzeb times. I think that would have been the end of Hindu civilization. It was so difficult because he had the largest territory ever from beyond Kabul to down south. But what happened? There was Shivaji, there was Guru Gobind Singh. Later the British came, then so many people came. Sri Ramakrishna came. Vivekananda came, hundreds of people came. Go back previously, Vijayanagar Empire was founded right in the middle of the Sultanates, and you had Vidyaranya. Some people say it's a myth, we don't know. But whatever it is, these people came, and Harihar Pukka came. And right in the middle of Agra and Delhi, you had Vrindavan. That's a miracle, it's impossible. There was no temple in North India. And somehow Chaitanya did this. Rupa Goswami, Jiva Goswami came. They had been converted. They had been converted by the Nawab of Murshidabad. He reconverted them. He sent them to Vrindavan. Now, this is not about religion I'm talking about, because there is Ras Khan also, who was a great Krishna Bhakt. This is about the Sanatani way. This is about the Sanatani Parampara. And this is about the uncolonized self. This is about Atmabal. Ke jab humne apne Atma ka sakshatkar kar liya, तो हम निडर हो जाते हैं. सो व्हाट आई एम सिंपली सेइंग इज, स्व की खोज हमारी पहचान है. स्वराज प्राप्त करना है, चाहे वो वैचारिक स्वराज हो, आर्थिक स्वराज हो, राजनैतिक स्वराज हो, किसी भी स्तर या क्षेत्र का स्वराज स्व से शुरू होगा. स्व की खोज ही हमारी पहचान है. सो वी आर नॉट एन आउटसाइड इन सिविलाइजेशन, वी आर एन इनसाइड आउट. और आई थिंक दिस मीटिंग हैज बीन वंडरफुल. ये गोष्ठी हमारे लिए बहुत ऊर्जात्मक हुई है, बहुत आशावादी हुई है. एंड आई थैंक ऑल ऑफ यू सिंसियरली फॉर ज्वाइनिंग दिस. एंड इस स्व की खोज से अगर हम स्व प्रकाशित हो जाए, तो हम पूरी दुनिया को उज्ज्वलित कर सकते हैं. ये हमारी परंपरा है, ये भारतीयता है. और इन्हीं शब्दों के साथ मैं एक और बार आप सबका इसमें स्वागत करता हूँ विनम्र तरीके से. और हम भट्ट साहब की बात पहले सुनेंगे, और वैलिडिक्ट्री एड्रेस के लिए वी हैव अ पर्सन हुज वर्क इज वेरी डियर टू माय हार्ट, तरुण विजय जी. विद दीज वर्ड्स, भट्ट साहब, ओवर टू यू.
थैंक यू. वी हर्ड ए वेरी इनलाइटनिंग प्रिफेटरी रिमार्क्स बाय प्रोफेसर मकरंद परांजपे. इनफैक्ट दैट हैज सेट द बैकग्राउंड for our deliberation. Friends, I am thankful to him and also to Professor Rajveer Sharma for asking me to share some of my ideas on the subject at hand. This idea of Atmanirbhar Bharat, as floated by our present Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi, has a hoary past. It goes back to the Vedic wisdom, wherein we have a propagation of such a noble and sublime ideas and ideals that Indian culture attracted scholars from all over the world, and they found it something to be worth pursuing and practicing. The Vedic Rishi himself declared, Sa Prathama Sanskriti Vishwavara. Ours is the most ancient culture. Perhaps people may dispute it, but in fact, it is a truth that ours is the most ancient culture and it has some such noble and sublime ideas that it is worth emulating by the whole world. The world did it, and even later on also we find scholars who are exposed to Indian culture, they find it to be extremely valuable, and therefore our culture has something which is unique and distinguishing, and which has made it survive all onslaughts of history. As Iqbal says, kuch baat hai ki hasti mitti nahi jaa. We have some survival instinct in us, and the survival instinct is provided by the sublime ideas and ideals which are enshrined in our culture. Our culture has a pretty long tradition, and a tradition, parampara, is that which is deeply rooted in the past, firmly footed in the present, but has a glorious view of the future. And therefore, our culture is not like a static pond. It is like a flowing river, wherein newer and newer tributaries join to enrich it. And in spite of several thousand years of slavery, we could maintain our culture intact. So we find, therefore, that there is a cultural continuity, not only in India, but outside India also, wherever an Indian has gone, our scholars have studied Indian culture. So we have Pravasi Bhartiya, they carry Indian culture abroad. And thus we have a cultural continuity in respect of our noble and sublime culture. Our culture has several distinguishing features. Some seminal concepts are there, and Swaraj is one of them. Like Dharma is another very significant concept. Purusharth is also there, referred to by Professor Makarand Paranjape. We have the concept of Yajna, we have the concept of Yoga, and so forth. There are many such concepts which are foundational for Indian culture. As regards Swaraj, let's look at its etymology. The word Swaraj has three etymological derivations. Svena rajate, swasmat rajate, sasmin rajate va. Three alternative but complementary derivations are available in our tradition. Svena rajate means one who exists by one's own self, self-existent, and self-shining, self-illuminating. Raj does not mean satta. Raj means to shine, to illuminate, to enlighten. So Svena rajate stands for one who is swashrita, self-dependent, swatantra, not being controlled by any alien factor, but self-controlling. We have the concept of sanyam for that in our tradition, and it also means swadhina. These are all, in fact, synonyms. In the Nasadiya Sukta, we have a very, I should say, pregnant concept, and that is the concept of swadha. Anidavatam swadhaya tadekam. The ultimate reality is unitary, and it is existing by its own potentiality. Swadha, swayam dharayati. It sustains itself. It does not depend upon anything. So this from swadha, later on we got the term dharma, swadharma, etc. So Svena Rajate stands for Swatantra. The reality, the essence of reality, the inherent nature of reality is to be self-shining. And therefore, Swarajya is the very essence of each and every existence which has emanated from one ultimate source. So when Tilak said, of course, in a different context, that स्वराज्य मेरा जन्मसिद्ध अधिकार है और मैं इसको लेकर के रहूंगा, तो देयर इट मींस दैट इट इज अवर वेरी इनर इसेंस, इट्स अवर वेरी बीइंग, इट इज अवर स्वत्व. एंड देयरफॉर स्वेन राजते इज अ वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट इटिमोलॉजी ऑफ द टर्म स्वराज्य. सेकंड इज स्वस्मात राजते, फ्रॉम वन्स ओन सेल्फ वी एग्जिस्ट. That means we do not depend upon others, and therefore we are Atmanirbhar. We therefore always have all our resources from our own surroundings, from our own nature. It is called as Swadeshi also in modern terminology. So Swasmat stands for Swadeshi. All our resources, because we have, see, we, according to Vedic rishis, we have emanated from the perfect, from the Purna, and we carry forward that the Purnata within us. Unfortunately, we under the sway of ignorance and other contaminating factors, we forget that we are perfect. And we experience ourselves as imperfect, and suffer from all sorts of disease and calamities. So Swasmat stands that we have a tremendous potentiality to be manifested, and our aim should be to this. In fact, the entire cosmic process has a built-in telos, a built-in teleology, and that teleology enables us to manifest, to have fullest possible efflorescence of our potentiality. And the third etymological derivation is swasmin. That means from within only we have to have all the resources, not from outside. But it does not mean that we do not depend upon other. Well, in our culture, we have been maintaining that ours is an interdependent existence. We have dependent origination and interdependent existence, and therefore we have not to be Koopa Manduka, a frog in a well, but we have to have a open-mindedness so that we may take help from others and provide help to others also. And therefore our rishis have floated three very seminal concepts, and that is sahavasa. We have to have a peaceful coexistence, sahakara. We should have a cooperative enterprises, and sahabhoga. Whatever is the result of our rational teleological enterprise, well, it should be enjoyed in togetherness with mutual caring and sharing. And therefore, this concept of Swaraja is very rich, has in fact immense possibilities of its understanding and its connotation. Now, basic connotation of the word Swaraj is metaphysical. And as Nasri Supta already said, Anid Vatam Swadhaya Tadekam. So it is one ultimate reality which is self-existent. But then that reality which is self-existent, it does not remain confined to itself. That reality manifests itself in multiple forms. Inner essence the same. but forms so change, and accordingly functions also change. So we do not have ek rupata, but we have ekatmata. The inner essence is the same. Well, this is what has been emphasized by of course our rishis, but has been reiterated by Mahatma Gandhi and Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay. Well, our approach therefore about the reality, about the entire cosmic process is not only teleological but also holistic, and in which we take into account all gamuts of reality, all aspects of reality, and therefore it is a metaphysical connotation of the term Swaraj is a foundational. Based on this, we have a moral, we have political, we have economic, and we have many other dimensions issuing forth from this metaphysical concept. Now, this Swaraj is basically intellectual. We have to think about our own self and also the surrounding universe, and therefore we have to have a true authentic awareness. Atmanam vijani, true authentic awareness of our own self, swa, but also of others which surround us, on which we have dependence, and which also depends upon us, this interdependence. So we may make a distinction between swa and para, but then swa and para are in an organic unity. Just as in an organism, we have multiple parts, each part has its own unique placement, its unique nature, its unique functioning, but in support with others. And therefore, a living organism is has a unity wherein there is a built-in multiplicity, and so it is both a unity in multiplicity and multiplicity in unity. It is both a centrifugal and also centripetal. So this has been the nature of reality envisaged by our ancient sages and seers, and therefore we find that it is this sort of awareness which is foundational. Unfortunately, because of centuries of slavery, we have lost this sort of awakening. We are in a dogmatic slumber because of this slavery, and therefore to great extent, we have forgotten the richness which is there handed down to us in our cultural heritage. And there is a time for reawakening, so that the dormant ideas and ideals inherent in our culture are made known for our own wellness, but also for cosmic wellness, because we don't talk in terms of self vis-a-vis or versus the other. Well, the other is also an intimate, integral part of our own self, and therefore we always talk of swa, of course, but the swa is to be extended, is to be universalized as a sarva. We never say that I alone should be happy. We say let all be happy, sarve bhavantu sukhinah, etc. So our notion of swa is not a limited one, not truncated one. It is something which is widest, which includes each and every existence. And this is what is known as adhyatma. Etat atmeidam sarvam, sarvam khalo idam brahma. And therefore we have been told that we have to be samadarshi. viewing all in our own self and viewing self as all in one and one in all. So this has been the adhyatmic or the spiritual approach to reality in our cultural tradition. But unfortunately, as I said earlier, because of foreign invasions and foreign rule, we have lost sight of this sort of intellectual wisdom. And we have become flunkyist. Always we look to others. And we think in terms of others. We find that most of our contemporary thinkers, they always look to the West. They ape the West. And in their thinking, the problems are borrowed from the West. The methodology is also borrowed from the West. The solutions are also borrowed from the West, which may not be conducive and suitable to our conditions and our aspirations. So we have this sort of flunkyist approach, which resulting in distortions, aberrations, and many such perversions, because we have ceased to be our own self. We have alienated ourselves from our own self. We have become alien, or to use another term, we have become a foreign babu. This is a derogatory term, babu, but we have become a babu. And, these days, many people address us as babu, those who are so-called intellectuals, they have become the babus. But this babu is nothing but a flunkyist. And this has been very rightly pointed out by Professor K.C. Bhattacharya. A reference has been made in the concept note to Professor K.C. Bhattacharya. I have quoted in my book, Indian Paradigm for Social Science Research, some of the utterances of Professor K.C. Bhattacharya, and I would like to read them. They are very, in fact, illuminating and enlightening, and they provide us a direction as to how we could have a vaicharik swatantra, a freedom in our ideas. The title of his essay also is Swaraj in Ideas. And it's a very seminal concept that he has propagated. He points out, he laments in the paper Swaraj in Ideas, and that how our thoughts have become hybrid through and through, and inevitable sterile slavery has entered into our very soul. We have, in fact, called hybridization and colonization of our mind. And he points out, therefore, that we either accept or repeat the judgments passed on us by Western culture, or we importantly resend them to the West, but have hardly any estimate of our own ideas wrung from our inward perception. He further observes, India's native soul gets twisted and warped by a shadow mind due to Western education. So it is the education which needs to be attended to. Fortunately, our present government is aware of that and is striving for that, hope that it succeeds. He writes again that slavery begins when one ceases to feel the evil, and it deepens when the evil is accepted as good. This is the most unfortunate situation, that we accept the evil as good. For example, we say who is a human being? A human being is a fighting animal, quarrelsome animal. But our culture doesn't say we are animal. We say we are divine spark, and we have a full of potentiality for realizing a virtuous life. And it is the virtuous life which needs to be valued, needs to be protected. Lord Krishna also says, Paritranaya Sadhunam. So, vices are to be eliminated and virtues are to be pursued and practiced. Again, Kesi Bhattacharya writes, intellectual bondage is more enslaving than political subjugation because of its invisibility and silent, creeping, paralyzing power, which unforgivably persists even after political independence. He makes a distinction between cultural assimilation and cultural subjugation. At present, what we have is cultural subjugation. But assimilation is not something undesirable. Our Vedic rishis also have said that we must get ideas from all over the world. Ano Bhadraha Karantu Shuta. From all over the world, let noble ideas come to us. But well, we have to assimilate them, we have to imbibe them, we have to make it a part of our own essence, our own being, our swatva. And therefore, as Mahatma Gandhi also used to say, same thing has been repeated by Pandit Nehru also, that we have to be firmly footed in our own side, so that we are not wiped away by the extraneous external influences. So it is this idea which is being advocated by Professor K.C. Bhattacharya. In fact, his small paper, which though he wrote in 1928, but was published only later on when we got independence. But then it is it has some very similar ideas. And it needs to be thoroughly studied and put to practice by Indian intellectuals. In our country, Brahma Tej was always regarded as most superior. Brahma Tej stands for this sort of intellectual freedom. And Satra Tej was regarded as subordinate to that. And this Brahma Tej stands for a universal outlook. Brahma stands for universality. And it, in fact, liberates one's oneself from all imperfections. It liberates others also from all imperfections. And therefore, we find that there is a need for cultural rejuvenation. This idea of a cultural rejuvenation or reawakening or revisiting our past. Our past is definitely noble and sublime, and it has been universally recognized to be so. And therefore, we have not to be ashamed of going back to the past, particularly to the Vedic wisdom. In my book, I have written a book on Vedic wisdom, cultural inheritance, and contemporary life. This is the title of my book. In that, I have argued that we have to go back to the Vedas, because from Vedas flow all our say noble traditions, our practices. And it has affected all aspects of our life. It enables us to have a establishment of a civil society, a vrati samaj. A vrati samaj is one wherein there is a peaceful coexistence, where there is cooperative enterprises, and where there is a reciprocal support, hearing, and sharing. And therefore, it's high time that we become aware of our glorious past. But this doesn't mean that we have to remain confined to the past. As I said, our culture is like a flowing river, and newer ideas should come, newer and newer innovation should come, newer and newer insights should come. Well, our rishis always insisted on this, that there has to be novelty. Khane khane yadnavtaun upeti tadeva rupam ramaniyataya. So this ramaniyata should be there. It is there as a characteristic of our culture. And therefore, we have to retain our culture. We have to see to it that what is living and what is dead. Because many distortions have taken place, which have made our culture some sort of, I should say, some sort of ridicule also. And people both within India and also India have ridiculed those elements which are aberrations in our culture. So we must have a judicious discrimination, what is to be retained and what is to be rejected. And therefore, we find that there has to be constant reformation. Our sages and seers have insisted on reformation, restructuring of the social structure, restructuring of the political order, restructuring of the economic order also. And for this, what we have to do is that we have to be guided by the classical wisdom that is handed down to us by our tradition. Because that classical wisdom is something which is, we call it Sanatana. We call it Sanatana Dharma. And therefore, it has that vitality to survive. It has that vitality to make us realize perfection. And therefore, we have to have that sort of judicious discrimination. I am of the opinion that no nation can survive and thrive if its semantic concepts, key terms, and basic ideas get mutilated, distorted, and become fossilized. And therefore, whatever is something to be discarded, we should do that. Even Dindayal Upadhyay, in his book Integral Humanism, of course, this title is not very happy. It should not be humanism. He himself didn't like this title. Anyway, there he points out that in an organism, if some organ is defective and vitiating the entire organism, we have to cut it off so that the health of the organism is maintained. In our culture also, therefore, all those healthy elements we have to reiterate, we have to emphasize, and of course, intellectual freedom, this panacea for this. But once we have this intellectual freedom, it should not remain a theoretical enterprise. It should transform our practice. Our mode of thinking should result in ways of living. And for that, therefore, we have to take help of political order. We have to take up economic order or social reconstruction as well. In social reconstruction, of course, we have believed in Varna Vyavastha, but unfortunately, it got they distorted as a jatiwad, and the jatiwad has become a curse to it. So we have to restore varna, and need not necessarily be chaturvarnya. It can be thousand varnas. Well, there are different vocations, and we should have a purity of vocation. Work is worship, and multiple works are needed for our multiple needs. And therefore, social restructuring is the need of the times. Likewise, in political order also, we have experimented with many forms of political governance, from kingship and aristocracy, syndicalism, guild syndicalism, and we have come to stay with democracy. But then there are many pitfalls of present democracy, and that's why this democracy also needs to be transformed into dharmocracy. The concept of dharma has been an overriding principle of Indian culture, and it is something which is foundational to our theory of Purusharth also, to which Professor Makarand Prahlade made a reference. And therefore, we want a dharmic individual, we want a dharmic society, we want a dharmic nation, we want a dharmic universe. So dharma centricity is something which is a need of the time. So similarly, our economic setup also, economic setup our economic transactions are for service purpose, to help, to serve, not for profit or motive. But unfortunately, present day individualistic, competitive, exploitative economic order in the name of globalization, well, we are only profiteering and depriving. So if you get the benefits of the economic development, and a majority gets deprived of that. So this economic order also needs to be changed. And our ancient religions have floated the idea of yoga and kshema. Very rich ideas are there for management of economy. They have also talked of asteya and parigraha. They are equally very rich ideas. So I think our economic planning should take help of these four parameters. I don't want to go into the details. I have a paper on that as to how our economic monetary policy should be shaped on the basis of ancient Indian culture, as it is expounded by, say, Manu, by Kautilya, and by many other Smritikaras. But it is the springs are there in the Vedic literature itself. The Vedas have given us some clues as to how we should have an ideal economic planning. And we have the example of, say, that is the first Tirthankara of Jain tradition. First Tirthankara, Rishabhadeva, his views on economics are discussed in the Vedas, in the Rig Veda. And therefore, we have to receive clues from that. Similarly, we have to coexist peacefully. Well, we feel that we are finite, we are imperfect, and in terms of calamities, we need some solace and succor from superhuman agencies, and therefore we think of God. But then there are multiple ways of understanding what is God, and in what way God can help us. So, ekamsa vipraha bodha vadanti, well, this is what is the Vedic saying to which Professor Paranjabe referred. And see, there are multiple pathways. All are say conducive to the realization of the ultimate goal, which is happiness. And therefore, this art of secularism means equal respect for all faiths is something which is the keynote of Indian culture. We don't understand secularism in Western sense as a separation of power between the church and the state. Not in that. Ours is there are alternative approaches to reality, and we must have a mutual understanding. In the Jain tradition, we have the theory of Anekantavada and Nayavada. Well, it is something which is really a distinguishing feature of our culture, and we have to emphasize it. Similarly, we have the concept of yoga, karma yoga particularly. Of course, yoga has jnana yoga, bhakti yoga, karma yoga, patanjal, raja yoga, and so forth. But this karma, the karma yoga, as it is propounded in the Bhagavad Gita, is something which is anasakta karma. That means we act in togetherness like a yajna. Yajna is always a cooperative enterprise. And in yajna, we perform our ahutis, and we say idam, ultimately, idam indraya swaha. It is not for us, it is for the totality. Indra stands for totality. So whatever is the result of the corporate activity, it should be enjoyed by all. And therefore, first we have to offer it to others. Ishavashukrishit, tena, chaktena bhunjita. First tyag and then bhog. This very significant concept of deep implication. Chaktena bhunjita. So the concept of tyag is something which is fundamental. And this is there if we have the anasakta bhava as it is propounded in the Bhagavad Gita. And similarly, in the Buddhist tradition, we have the concept of bodhisattva, a very significant ideal that has been put forth for us to emulate and practice. So my point is that in our culture, there are many sublime ideas, concepts, theories, and practices. They are not, theories are not just verbose. They are to be put to practice. And therefore, our approach is always teleological. We postulate values so that values are pursued and practiced. So this valuational approach has to be there. And if we do that, definitely we shall enrich ourselves. And this is what is meant by being Atmanirbhar. But this Atma is not Swatma. This Atma is Sarvatma. We must make this distinction between selfish egocentricity and this altruistic understanding of the totality. So if we can do that, then this Atmanirbhar Bharat concept can be properly understood and also put to practice, because it's the practice which is most significant and important. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to say a few words on this particular topic at hand. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for the that magisterial survey of our entire civilization's orientation, where you ranged far and wide from the Vedas to the first prophet of, rather, first Tirthankar of Jainism, Rishabhnath, to the Bodhic Sattva ideals, codependency, Pratitya Samutpada. So you brought in all the threads of our civilization and its orientation. And I'm just reminded of how in Kashmir Trika philosophy, there is no difference between aham and om. You see, so the small self has no scope. Tena tyaktena bhunjita is automatic, because your self is nothing other than Shiva, you see. But as you said, this is easier said than done. We are a society and civilization which is not only teleological, as you said, but also soteriological. In other words, We are a society of tapas and of jnana. So we have to struggle. I'll just give you a word. The only thing I wanted to say, which really struck me, dharmocracy. I love that. Dharmocracy. We have to be not just a democracy, but a dharmocracy. And then the shadow mind of Krishnachandra Bhattacharya, we started with him in our keynote. I'm glad you brought in Krishnachandra Bhattacharya again. 1928, he gave a famous lecture at Hooghly College. In 1931, this lecture was published. But it immediately reminds us of the allegory of the cave in Plato's Republic. See, if you read it again, it's fantastic because, you know, when the person is freed from the cave where he only sees shadows, he's blinded by the sun and he goes back to the cave. He says, "Mujhe nahi aana, suraj ki roshni mujhe nahi bhati." And then the people in the cave become so fanatical that anybody who wants to get out of the cave or who wants to help them go out of the cave, they want to beat him up. So sometimes we get so attached to our chains. And then secondly, which was again our human tendency, aapne swatantra ki baat ki. Again, it's a technical term, swatantra versus paratantra. This swatantra is a characteristic of Shiva, who is swatantra. Anyhow, but what I'm trying to say is, ek bedia kisi ne tod di, to hum dusri bedia chahte hain. You know, we do not want to move from bondage to freedom. We want to move from one bondage to another kind of bondage. So this is our problem. And now the challenge before us is what I would call digital recolonization. Digital recolonization, because most of our time is spent, you know, on these devices. Half our brain is stored on the device, and big tech controls these devices. They don't want to go by the laws of the land. The largest users are in India. Facebook has 400 million users, 450 million, which is more than the population of US in India. WhatsApp, maximum users of WhatsApp anywhere in the world are in India. When it comes to Twitter, India is number three. After US, Japan, India is number three. The number three market is India. And yet they don't want to be responsible. What they post, they don't want to take responsibility. We don't know whether they want to be intermediaries. If they are intermediaries, why are they marking some content as offensive or as unreliable? You can't have it both ways. You see, either you're just a hosting platform, you're neutral, but on the other hand, they're slamming you. You know, I will tell you my own example, and then I will request Tarun Vijayji to deliver the valedictory. You know, ever since I started flagging this issue, the number of my followers today is 89,500. Okay? And it never becomes 89,600. Six times it crosses 600, then they bring it back to 540, 50, 60. Then after 5 days, 7 days, it goes to 89,600. Again, they bring it back. Now, I can't think this is some random algorithm. I think this is a direct punishment, so to speak, for constantly bringing up this issue. And of course, Arun Vijayji can enlighten us, but I think the real way to get out of this is this pleasure centers in the brain. They are manipulating the pleasure centers, the reward centers. The brain has reward centers. So when you do something good, you feel rewarded. So what I'm trying to say is we should get out of giving this power to Twitter and social media, instant like, you know, instant retweet. Isse kya hai? Ye hamari gulami ka sadhan ban rahe hain. Ke hum din mein सारा टाइम ट्विटर में है, फेसबुक पे है, और जो हमारी आत्म छवि है, सेल्फ इमेज है, हमने उन पर सौंप दी है. तो उनको हमने अधिकार दे दिया है टू मेक अस फील गुड अबाउट आवरसेल्फ्स. अप्रूवल डिसअप्रूवल, लाइक अनलाइक, प्लेजेंट अनप्लेजेंट. योग सूत्र में ये लिखा है कि जो हमारी चित्त वृत्तियां हैं, ये क्लिष्ट या अक्लिष्ट होती हैं. सो इफ यू रीड the Yoga Sutra in the light of today's digital manipulation of your consciousness, you will see how the great rishis have already understood how the mind functions. And to me, I got help from the Yoga Sutra. sutras. Not that I was addicted to Twitter or any other medium, I'm just saying. But when it troubled me, I got help from the Yoga Sutras. कि इसको हम मन को इससे कैसे हम डिटैच कर लें, यू नो. एंड आई थिंक दिस इज अ ग्रेट थिंग फॉर अस. आई विल नाउ इनवाइट तरुण विजय जी टू गिव हिज वैलिडिक्टरी एड्रेस प्लीज. इफ यू वांट टू से सम वर्ड्स राजवीर जी टू इंट्रोड्यूस तरुण विजय जी, यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम, बट वेरी ब्रीफली.
तरुण विजय जी का तो स्वागत में जितना कहा जाए वो कम है. वास्तव में सच्चाई ये है कि तरुण जी बहुत समय से एक बौद्धिक विमर्श में लगे हुए हैं और बहुत सारे जो यंगस्टर्स हैं, खासतौर पर यंग इंटेलेक्चुअल्स हैं, उनकी प्रेरणा के स्रोत हैं. बस मैं इतना ही कहूँगा. पहले आप इंट्रोडक्शन करा चुके हैं. थैंक यू एंड वेलकम.
थैंक यू. थैंक यू मकरंद जी, एंड माय प्रणाम टू ऑल द बौद्धिक क्षत्रियाज एंड द इंटेलेक्चुअल वॉरियर्स हुम आई सी हियर, एंड congratulations for leading a war against the colonization. I see the same spirit here that perhaps our ancestors felt in 1857, and I firmly believe that this is again an 1857 to fight against the intellectual and internet colonizers. It's a fight that is as important as the political independence was. And I begin with the quote of Dr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee, the greatest decolonizer and the fighter against the colonizing the mind of the conspired by the British. When he was the vice chancellor of Kolkata University, he was the first person to invite the Kavi Guru Rabindranath Tagore to give a convocation address in Bengali. And no surprise that because of the British rule, it was prohibited that no convocation address, that no major thing could happen except in English, was not allowed in any Indian languages. He was the illustrious son of Ashutosh Mukherjee, and when he was doing the post-graduation, his father said that it's better you do the post-graduation in Bengali. Of course, he was always the first class first and the gold medal holder for all his classes. And he did post-graduation not in English literature, but in Bengali language. And he stood first class first and got the gold medal. And he said in one of his addresses in the Kolkata University, that our political independence will be incomplete if we don't have the freedom to think independently, act independently, and preserve and promote our own language, culture, civilizational values. That was exactly what the British were doing. And I must remind that in 1931, when Mahatma Gandhi went to the Roundtable Conference in London, he spoke about a beautiful tree and said that before the British arrived in India, India was more literate, more cultured, more schools, and more literacy prevailed here. And that was a beautiful tree he spoke about. More literacy was there before the British came. The biggest attack of a colonizer, of an invader, is on the memory. They are the biggest memory erasers and the library burners, what Sir Vidyasagar Naipaul has said in one of his essays in the New York Times, that the Hindus suffer from a memory loss. And why? Because the invaders never want the subjugated people to keep the memories of their ancestors, their glory, their victory, their happiness, their climax of progress preserved. They would like to say that it was the British who shaped us, it was the British who gave us the nation, it was the British who gave us the iron frame of the ICS, it was the British who gave us the trains. And they civilized us so much so that the first Prime Minister of India, Nehru, he told one of the American ambassadors, John Kenneth Galbraith, that I am the last Englishman to rule India. That was the kind of the pride that the British education, the English education system gave to the Indians, that to be British, to ape the British protocols and use their language in home, outside, is a mark of being an intellectual, being someone who is progressive, and he is achieved a big goals in his life. I must say that what Shri Bhatji had said, that we are facing a cultural subjugation, very rightly said. We are still a colonized people, we are still a colonized governance system. Right from the Parliament House, every single protocol in parliament is a British parliament, and that's the signatures of a colonized mind. In judiciary, in bureaucracy, in police, everywhere we see the signatures of the colonized mindset. The Gita says that swadharme nidhanam shreyah par dharmo bhayavah. It's better to die in your own dharma. Apne dharma mein nidhan. Apne dharma ka artha hai ki what is the right thing that we feel and what is the way of life that we feel is the dharma, as Dr. Radhakrishnan also said. I see here in the Indian Institute of Advanced Study the same kind of a platform. Perhaps in the 19th century we saw when Lal Bal Pal were fighting not only against the British slavery but also to free the Indian mind. They were the great intellectual warriors. Lokmanya Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Bipin Chandrapal, Sri Aurobindo, Swami Vivekanand, they decolonized the Indian mind. And the greatest happening that happened to decolonize the Indian mind was in the form of the foundation of Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh in 1925 by Dr. Kesha Rao Baliram Hedgewar. He was the biggest impact on the Indian mind, who decolonized, who began a great movement, a revolutionary movement to decolonize the Indian mind, and fought against everything what the British had brought here. It was Dr. Hedgewar who celebrated the Congress Purn Swaraj resolution that was passed on 26 January 1930, exactly 45 years after the foundation of Congress. Congress took 45 years to pass the resolution of Purn Swaraj, and Dr. Hedgewar wrote to all the Swayamsevak all over India to celebrate this day and congratulate Congress, because finally, there is a day when Congress has agreed to pass the resolution of Purna Swaraj. That's the impact of the British. That was the impact of the English education. That was the result of a colonized mind, that even the best of the Congress leaders could not agree to pass the resolution of Purna Swaraj for full 45 years. Makranji, I would like to come to the horror of digital colonization. But before that, I would like to show a little bit that how the colonized mind is still active in India. You know, one of the state in India is still having a Persian name. So much so that even the small FIRs in the police thanas, they are written not in the Indian language. People, I got some of the FIRs and wrote an article in the organizer that how the FIRs in Delhi are filed. They are completely in the Persian language. Even the person, the constable and the sub-inspector who files the FIR would not understand what he's writing, but it is continuing, and we are continuing with this system that the Persianized FIRs are still in vogue in our police thanas. So much so that we are celebrating those monuments of people who had attacked, assaulted, looted, marauded and plundered India. I would give just two examples. You know who Afzal Khan was. He wanted to trap Shivaji and to kill him. But Shivaji was much cleverer, and some of the people around Afzal Khan told him that perhaps you may not be able to come back. He was so afraid of it that the day he had to go to meet Shivaji, earlier night, he slaughtered his 62 wives. He had 62 wives. And he was afraid that perhaps he may not come back. So 62 wives were slaughtered by that Afzal Khan. We have a national monument of importance devoted, dedicated to those 62 wives in Bijapur. If you Google the Sat Kabar, it's a national monument. It's a monument of national importance today, but the Samadhi of Tarabai, who ruled Maharashtra for 30 years. He was a terror for Aurangzeb, and she was a great warrior. Her Samadhi is in a very dilapidated condition in Satara. That's how the colonized minds work. This is the condition. There was a British postman who was coming from Meerut to Delhi with a letter of a British major for sending immediate reinforcements to face the revolutionaries of 1857. In the way, some of the villagers got to know that he is a British stooge, he is going to get the more reinforcement for the British major in Meerut. They caught him, killed him. The British later on honored that British postman and made a grave in his honor. That grave is today is a monument of national importance. That is how the colonized minds have worked. We go to the Qutub Minar, that's I say that the Minaret of Hate, the King Anangpal established Delhi in 11th century. Not a single place is in Delhi. Not a single place is in Delhi, Makranji, which celebrates the founder of Delhi. It was Lord Cunningham who found many of the scriptures and inscriptions on stone, which are now kept in Purana Kila in Delhi, which have a Sanskrit inscriptions that the earlier name of Delhi was Dhilika Puri, and how King Anangpal established it and built beautiful 27 Hindu and Jain temples in Mehroli. Beautiful, grand temples, grand temples. When Qutubuddin Aibak came, he killed all the people there, demolished all the temples, and used all the Hindu Jain sculptures in the Quwwatul Islam Mosque. Today, it bleeds my heart to say that, can I have some AC? I'm feeling sweated. Today, when I go to Qutub Minar and see there, I see upside down Ganesha, where the people's feet are there. आज भी लगा हुआ है उल्टे गणेश, वहां पे गणेश हमारे चरणों में है, वहां तीर्थंकर है, ऋषभ देव है, यमुना की मूर्ति है, नवग्रह है, दशावतार है, सब कुछ है, लेकिन हम इतने कॉलोनाइज्ड गुलाम मानसिकता के लोग हैं कि जब हमारे लोग वहां जाते हैं तो उल्टे गणेश के साथ सेल्फी खींचते हैं, सेल्फी विद अपसाइड गणेश, एंड हु गोज देयर फॉर द पिकनिक, हु सेलिब्रेट्स कुतुब मीनार in every single advertisement by any agency. It is the Qutub Minar which represents Delhi. It is the Qutub Minar that represents Delhi and not the Anang Tal and not the Lal Kot of Prithviraj Chauhan. That is the slavish mind. The slavish mind is also expressed in one of the more very atrocious kind of historical blunders. There was light and sound show in Purana Kila going on, and the name was that the history of Delhi. It was considered to be in Hindi, but the whole show was in Persian language. And what they showed that how the Khiljis, Lodis, Humayuns, Tughlaqs, they were in love of Delhi. Delhi ke ishq mein, yehi uska shirshak tha. दिल्ली के इश्क में आए थे ये सुल्तान, उनकी बारादरी, उनके डांसेस, उनके ड्रामास, उनके रंगरेलियां, उनका खाना पीना, उनका मुगली कुजीन, यह सब एक महानता की निशानी बन गए. वी गॉट इट स्टॉप्ड. क्यों? क्योंकि मेरा इतना पश्चाताप और दुख हुआ मुझे वहां जब देखा तो एक अक्षर, एक वाक्य भी नहीं था कि दिल्ली को सिखों ने जीता था बाबा बघेल सिंह के नेतृत्व में. जो 30,000 की अदालत है दिल्ली में, ये इसलिए है क्योंकि 30,000 सिखों की छावनी थी. उन्होंने लाल किला जीता, मुगल बादशाह को हराया, उसे संधि करवाई, और बाबा बघेल सिंह ने दिल्ली को जीतकर दिल्ली के जो 7 गुरुद्वारे आज दिख रहे हैं हमें, इंक्लूडिंग गुरुद्वारा शीशगंज साहेब वेयर गुरु तेग बहादुर साहब वाज मार्टिर्ड, उसको उन्होंने, बाबा बघेल सिंह ने बनवाया. वहां पे पहले एक मस्जिद थी, बाबा बघेल सिंह ने वह मस्जिद तुड़वाकर वहां पे गुरुद्वारा बनाया, रकाबगंज, नानक का प्यार, जितने ये बड़े 7 गुरुद्वारे हैं, एक भी गुरुद्वारा नहीं था वो बाबा बघेल सिंह ने बनवाया था. और लाल किले में सिंहासन पर जस्सा सिंह अहलूवालिया को बिठाया था, निशान साहब लहराया था, एक अक्षर आप मुझे दिखा दीजिए कि किसी भी पाठ्य पुस्तक पे, नॉट अ सिंगल टेक्स्ट बुक इन इंडिया और इन दिल्ली और एल्सवेयर मेंशंस दैट द सिक्स कंक्वर्ड दिल्ली. द सिक्स वर द फर्स्ट पीपल हु कंक्वर्ड दिल्ली, डिफीटेड द मुगल्स एंड एस्टैब्लिश्ड द सेवन गुरुद्वारास. देन देयर इज नो मेंशन ऑफ द मराठा कंक्वेस्ट ऑफ दिल्ली. महादजी शिंदिया केम हियर फॉर द एंटायर वन ईयर. दे रूल्ड दिल्ली एंड द एडजेसेंट एरियाज. दे डिफीटेड द मुगल्स. They had the Bhagwa Dhwaj on Red Fort. Not a single line mentions here, and nobody celebrates the day. Nobody celebrates the day when they had conquered Delhi and had their own rule established. That was the freedom movement. Only a free mind, only an intellectual warrior, only a Bodhi Kshatriya would remind people of that. And that reminds me once again that V.S. Naipaul said that the people here are suffering from a memory loss. And that's what the Twitter, that's what the Google, that's what the these foreign digital agencies, they do. They colonize the mind. They colonize the mind and make the people forget everything. Makranji, you will be shocked to see that we go to the Viceroy Palace, now known as a Rashtrapati Bhavan. And where do our governments take oath? Modi ji ne to bahar liya. After Shyama Prasad Mukherjee, Narendra Modi is the first person who is decolonizing the Indian mind. And I congratulate him for the Central Vista Project. Central Vista Project is nothing but a great step forward for decolonize the Indian mind, decolonize Delhi. Lutyens Delhi ki jo gulami hai, usse mukti ka ek udghosh hai Central Vista Project. लेकिन राष्ट्रपति भवन में हमारे जो भी सरकार शपथ लेती है वो किस छत के नीचे लेती है? वहां पे राम कृष्ण गुरु गोविंद सिंह गुरु तेग बहादुर साहब भगत सिंह चंद्रशेखर इनके चित्र नहीं है मकरंद जी, उसके ऊपर चित्र है नादिर शाह का. नादिर शाह का चित्र है वहां पे एक तुर्की बेगम जो है वो मक्का जा रही है उसका चित्र है. उसकी छाया तले भारत की नई सरकारें शपथ लेती हैं. क्या ये विडंबना नहीं है? वहां पे भारत और भारतीयता का प्रकटीकरण करने वाला अभिव्यक्ति देने वाला कोई चित्र नहीं होता है. इस दास्ता से मुक्ति का संग्राम ही डिजिटल इंटरनेट कॉलोनाइजेशन से मुक्ति का संग्राम है. यह एक नवीन 1857 है और इसके लिए मैं आपको बधाई देता हूं कि आपने इसको बहुत महत्व के साथ लिया है. मैं एक और बात आपको बताना चाहता हूं कि आपने ट्विटर पे जेम्स ऑफ बॉलीवुड का एक हैंडल देखा होगा. हिला के रख दिया बॉलीवुड के तमाम गुलामों को. वे गुलाम जो मुगलों के अस्तबल में घोड़ों की लीद उठाने वाले थे, वे गुलाम जो मुगलों के अस्तबल साफ करने वाले थे, वे वहां पे बड़ी बड़ी फिल्में दिखाते हैं, बनाते हैं. और क्या दिखाते हैं? हिंदुओं का अपमान, हिंदुओं का मजाक उड़ाना, हिंदुओं पर छींटाकशी करना. जब मैं दारू पीता हूं तो मुझे राम और सीता दिखते हैं. ये गाना भी गाने वाला बॉलीवुड का एक्टर होता है, लेकिन किसी के हृदय में उसको लेकर कोई उद्वेग, कोई गुस्सा पैदा नहीं होता. ये जो है ये डिजिटल कॉलोनाइजेशन और अंग्रेजी का के स्कूलों की शिक्षा का एक परिणाम होता है. यह एक युद्ध लड़ना पड़ेगा. मैं उसके जेम्स ऑफ बॉलीवुड के दोनों जो उसके निर्माता सर्जक हैं उनको बहुत बधाई देना चाहता हूं. उन्होंने ये जो कॉलोनाइजेशन है इसके बारे में बहुत बड़ा एक आंदोलन जैसा शुरू कर दिया है ट्विटर पे. और बॉलीवुड के जो गुलाम हैं, साईस दरबारी, जिनको हिंदुस्तान मालूम नहीं, जो भारत से परिचित नहीं, जिनको भारतीयता की परिभाषा मालूम नहीं, जो अपना नाम का परिचय तक नहीं देना चाहते, जो अपनी माटी की सुगंध के विरुद्ध लड़ते हैं, उनको पैसा चाहिए और थोड़ी सी शोहरत चाहिए, उन सबको इस जेम्स ऑफ बॉलीवुड ने भी बेनकाब किया है. लेकिन हमारी लड़ाई उन लोगों से है जो हमारे दिमाग को, हमारे मन के भीतर के विचारों को अमेरिका और दूसरे पश्चिमी ताकतों के पास ले जाते हैं, चीन के पास ले जाते हैं. दिस इज द बिगेस्ट थ्रेट दैट वी आर फेसिंग एंड दैट्स द इंटरनेट कॉलोनाइजेशन. आई वाज द फर्स्ट मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट टू रेज इन राज्यसभा. And when he said that the entire house across the party lines, they supported me. You will be surprised to see and know that it was a Google which violated the Indian laws. And first time a government agency, Survey of India, filed a first information report against Google. I raised in the parliament, Google was doing the mapathon. And for mapathon meant that every single inch of India would go as a picture, as a map to the American agencies. And you know that how the Google and Yahoo and these agencies report every single data, and they are bound to share their data with the American NSA, National Security Advisor, and that has come on a record. Now, I said that a map is subject to government approval in India. And in the regard of Google Mapathon, we wanted that the Google should have taken the approval of the government first and shown their project and their plan to the Survey of India first, but they did not do it. I said that any private agency which undertakes map data preparation and marks localities, buildings, etc., referred to as points of interest, that is known as POIs, on the scale larger than 1:50,000, should be vetted by Ministry of Defense for any VAs, vulnerable areas, and VPs, vulnerable points. Important government buildings, oil storages, critical flyovers, airports, cantonments, etc., are generally considered vulnerable areas and vulnerable points. In the past too, Google was asked to refrain from publishing such data, like marking of warships in Naval Dockyard in Mumbai was done by Google. And even Professor APJ Abdul Kalam had raised serious objection in such Google operations. Similarly, Google was asked to stop from collecting street imagery with GPS coordinate, as it had not taken permission from concerned agencies. Knowingly or unknowingly, publishing such data, which is P or VP endangers security and violates mapping policy. You know that terrorists are increasingly relying on sophisticated technology and internet services, including Google Earth, maps, and satellite phones for their horrible plans. The Ministry of Science and Technology and Survey of India are the two authorities responsible for mapping the country. No other agency, but still Google is doing that. And Google is doing with such a mischief that it shows Kashmir in Pakistan and half of the Kashmir in China. It shows the entire Arunachal Pradesh in China. Nobody is doing anything. The country's national mapping policy allows only the Survey of India to prepare maps. But what did they do? They showed naval dockyards, nuclear and oil establishments, and Rashtrapati Bhavan. Similarly, sir, the mapathon policy was stopped. There was a CBI inquiry against Google. And they started it, but I don't know what happened. Now, Google reached the Surveyor General of India. They tried to have it covered, but they could not do so. But I'm sure that even the inquiry against Google was shelved. Similarly, the Twitter, you know, how the Twitter is working. I had written a lot about how the Twitter works, but with one of the think tanks in India, we had been working for the last several years, that the mapping of Indian mind, the pattern of how an Indian spends, whom they send the emails, what is the content of the email, who are their contact people, who are the people who are very close to their heart and with whom they share their thoughts. Every single thing that we share on Gmail, on Yahoo, that can be accessed by Google, and we sign it. We sign it before we open the account without reading the fine print without reading the fine print. We sign everything. So the Google, Yahoo, and all these foreign-based internet agencies, they are privy to all our emails, to all our views, to all our contacts. They know the pattern of our activities. They know the pattern of our thought exchanges, and that's what makes them to control the mind. We know that how the NGO circuit in Delhi and elsewhere is working. Within 10 minutes, one of the persons and one who is working in the intelligence said that, sir, they are getting so much of foreign money that within 10 minutes, they have the capacity to collect 10,000 people at any given point in Delhi. And we had seen in couple of incidents that the power of the foreign controlled NGOs in Delhi passes through the foreign based digital agencies. These digital colonizers are not just facilitators, which they innocently look like for our exchange of views or emails. They are also the big conspirators against the Indian state. And that's the reason whenever there is a uprise or there is a the Hindutva people try to organize a big conference, or they try to hold their views on Kashmir or on Ayodhya on 370 and other northeastern sector insurgency. These are the agencies, digital agencies. They control our choices through Google search. They give us the options that they want us to read. They don't give us the searches we really need. There's hardly much on the Hindutva icons on these internet platforms. There is not much that the internet users who are adherents of Shyama Prasad Mukherjee and Deen Dayal Upadhyay and RSS ideology or Hindutva, which is the dominant ideology in India, is setting the agenda, and the people of India have voted for this ideology for the last two consecutive terms. They voted it during Atal Bihari Vajpayee time. They voted during Modi one time. They voted for Modi two times. But the will of the people of India is sought to be violated and negated by these agencies through their mind controlling digital capabilities. That is the biggest danger. And that's how I think we have to look to ourselves. Most of the contracts, why are we giving to Google? Why are we not strengthening our own instruments like NIC, like Bhuvan, like Survey of India? The biggest and the greatest and the best mapping agency in India can only be Survey of India and not Google Earth or Google Mapping. And the Google Pro is not, Earth Pro is not even available in India. Why are we not doing that? That's the question. It's very easy to say that the British were a handful of people, 70,000, but they subjugated us, and from Calcutta to Kashmir, they had their rule. But the bitter truth is that we were available for that subjugation. We were not united. We were not able to fight out the British. We are not able to preserve our school system. It is only through the Saraswati Shishu Mandir network of the RSS, which Nanaji Deshmukh began in Gorakhpur, that the decolonization of Indian mind through school curriculums is being done today. But except that Saraswati Shishu Mandir network, how many schools you think where the stories of Velunachyar, Andal, Avayar, Tiruvalluvar, Guru Govind Singh, Hakikat Rai, the two Sahabjadas who were walled alive in Sarhand, Guru Tegh Bahadur Sahib, Bhai Mati Das, Bhai Sati Das, or Banda Singh Bahadur. Give me one lesson of these English educated, most of them Christian educated schools, where they are teaching the stories of our heroes and warriors. No, decolonization of Indian mind and fight against the digital internet subjugation begins in our school and begins with the Ministry of Education and Ministry of IT. I congratulate Ravi Shankar Prasad ji, and I congratulate and salute the great spirit and the leadership that Narendra Modi ji is giving against the digital colonization, and the fight against this kind of a colonization can only be made a success if people are made aware. I congratulate Makaranda Paranjapeh ji. He has started something really big and great. I hope that other people will follow the suit, and this war against the digital subjugation, digital slavery, it's a war against those who are fighting against the soul of India, that must succeed. Antim vijay hamari hogi, kyunki hamare saath satya hai aur dharma hai. Hato va prapsasi swargam, jitva va bhokshase mahim, tasmad uttishtha kaunteya yuddhaya krita nishchaya. So Makarand ji ne yuddh ka nishchay kar liya hai. Main unko bahut badhai deta hu, apne mujhe ye kuch baat kehne ka अवसर दिया, इसके लिए मैं आपका धन्यवाद अर्पित करता हूं। धन्यवाद और जय हिंद।
It was a rousing and inspiring oration. Thank you so much. In fact, I myself didn't know a few things. I didn't know. I've been to Rashtrapati Bhavan a couple of times. I'm not aware that there is Nadir Shah sitting there, the same Nadir Shah who destroyed Delhi, and in one day he slaughtered more than 30,000 people. And that I think the day was 22nd of March 1793, so much so that I remember the poet Mir Taqi Mir, who said Delhi jo ek shahar tha alam mein intikhab, हम रहने वाले हैं उसी उजड़े दयार के. सो आई मीन जिस शहर को उन्होंने उजाड़ दिया, उनकी तस्वीर राष्ट्रपति भवन में है. माय गुडनेस, आई मीन आई लर्नड लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स टुडे. आई डिड नो अबाउट
इट. नहीं, एक मिनट मकरंद जी, पूरी दिल्ली में जिसने दिल्ली को बसाया अनंगपाल, एक चेहरा, एक निशान, एक मेंशन दिखा दीजिए दिल्ली में. गुरु
मैं मानता हूं. आई एग्री अबाउट दैट. आई डिडंट नो नादिर शाह वाज इन राष्ट्रपति भवन. ये मेरे लिए
बंदा सिंह बहादुर.
यस यस यस,
उनकी शहादत दिल्ली में हुई. उनको तड़पा तड़पा के मारा, उनकी गोद में 6 साल के बेटे अजय सिंह को मारा. उनके साथ 740 सिख आए थे. उन 740 सिखों को हर दिन 100 सिखों को दिल्ली, पुरानी दिल्ली स्टेशन के बाहर जो पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी आज बनी है उस स्थान पे हर दिन 100 सिखों को मारा. क्या आप किसी से पूछें तो आपको मालूम चलेगा कि बाबा बंदा सिंह बहादुर की शहादत की तीर्थ स्थान दिल्ली में कहाँ है? कोई नहीं बता पाएगा. ये हम हैं जो 740 सिखों को स्लॉटर किया पुरानी दिल्ली स्टेशन के बाहर. वहां पे एक पत्थर भी नहीं लगा हुआ. ये दुख होता है. दिल्ली में सिखों की विजय का एक पत्थर नहीं लगा. हम लगवा रहे हैं, मोदी सरकार लगवा रही है. तो ये दिस इज अ फाइट अगेंस्ट द कॉलोनाइजेशन. और ये जो गुलाम दास मानसिकता है, यह हमको हमारे जो आलस्य है, प्रमाद है, उसे झकझोर कर खड़ा करने में समर्थ होनी चाहिए. ये मैं आपसे विनती करता हूं.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. और जहां तक डिजिटल कॉलोनाइजेशन का सवाल है, हम सब जानते हैं हमारे उत्तराखंड में एक पर्वत है जिसका नाम है श्री कैलाश, और उसको चाइना में दिखाया गया है नागरी प्रिफेक्चर में गूगल मैप्स में. मैंने ट्वीट भी किया था, सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया को भी मैंने बताया था, लेकिन अभी भी वो दुरुस्त नहीं है. और जो हमारी टेरिटरी अक्षय चिन्ह में और सो कॉल्ड पाकिस्तान ऑक्यूपाइड कहिए, वो लोग आज़ाद कश्मीर कहते हैं, वो तो वैसा है ही, दुनिया भर में है. लेकिन कई ऐसी दूसरी डिस्टॉर्शंस हैं, विकृतियां हैं जो आप बता रहे हैं, और आपने इन इन बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट चीज़ों को आज आपने फ्लैग किया है, इसके लिए मैं आभारी हूं. कुछ लोगों के सवाल भी आ रहे हैं, और अफजल खान, वो मुझे पता है 60 बीवियों का वो मकबरा, वो मालूम था मुझे. लेकिन मैं ये कहना चाह रहा हूँ, आई कंसिडर माई सेल्फ अ लिटिल एजुकेटेड, पर मुझे भी कई चीज़ों के बारे में पता नहीं था. That is what I want to say to you, that you have enlightened us by bringing in some material that I myself also didn't know. So this correction is very, very important, so that the gaps in our perception. And the other important thing you said is the destruction of memory. You know, why is it that the Jewish people will come up with a Holocaust memorial wherever they go? Kahin bhi jayenge, they will remember, because this forgetting is so deadly that you forget who you are. And in a way, I'm full of these ideas from Kashmiri Shaivism. Inka ek pura school hai, Pratap Bhigya. जब आप अपने आप दोबारा से, जैसे कोई शेर है उसने अपनी छवि एक पडल ऑफ वाटर में देखी, तब उसको पता चला कि वो शेर है. एक्चुअली ही वाज रेज्ड अमंग द लैम्स, और उसको लगा कि मैं भी एक भेड़ी हूँ, भेड़िया भेड़ी हूँ. सो उस तरह से मैं कह रहा था कि ये जो यू नो सेल्फ रिकग्निशन, दिस इज सो इम्पोर्टेंट व्हेन अ civilization has to stand up again on its feet. And for this, all the things that you are telling us about, the commemoration, the correction, the filling in of gaps, Anangpal ki Delhi, wo stamp to unka hota hai wahan, Anangpal ka jo iron pillar hai, uske bare mein, somehow people want to put their hands behind the pillar and touch it, which is very strange because it's too big to put your hands behind that pillar. But of course, uski anokhi metallurgy ke bare mein, even the British took a piece of that pillar and they said, isme kya hai ye rust, kyun usko jang kyun lagi, nahi lagi. So those are mysteries, but anyhow, I will come back in a few minutes.
ek chota correction hai, jo Rashtrapati Bhavan mein upar chitra hai wo Fateh Ali Shah ka hai, jo Iran ke Fateh Ali Shah ka hai.
Sorry, okay, mujhe sunai diya Nadir Shah, but पंडिता जी गो हैड.
The other somebody said that our IITs, we are using Google Meet, we are using free Microsoft Teams, and these organizations, companies are all our opinion in and look on us and they out. But everything our idea, all these free equipment, and therefore we are literally like selling away our, giving away our things for MOOC. There was another, the reason I'm saying this is because there was a person called Ramana who had a code Tantra platform he created, indigenous created, made in India. He came to IIT Kharagpur. He was saying the tender. But if we are in the need for the using it, online come to stay. So if one can seriously reconsider this, because I think it's very dangerous how we are, exposing ourselves, as you rightly said. And all the top institutes, or even this, for example, must be snooped upon. And then that material will be used against us in a different way. I would love to hear your thoughts on whether we can, again, strategically promote indigenous platforms, even if it costs, but if it's a bargain, that is one. And my question to Asad Bhatji was this, that Atmanirbhar Bharata, can we also say Swanirbhar Bharata? Would there be a difference if we said Swanirbhara and Atmanirbhara? This is the question. Thank you very much for your dharmocracy. It's completely with the gross dharma practice, it's like fit. So I will reach out to you also, Bhanji, because I've connected earlier with you as well. I'll do that.
Okay, before you answer, I just immediately went and checked Ashoka Hall in the Rashtrapati Bhavan does have a portrait of the Persian lady and Fateh Ali Shah. I immediately checked, but Nadir Shah Haini. That's number one. Number two, about these platforms, we got a note from the ministry saying do not use Zoom. In fact, we had a more advantageous subscription of Zoom. We have moved from Zoom to Cisco WebEx. And Huawei, this Chinese company, everybody knows that people are spying. Cyber spying is now, in fact, cyber warfare is going to be much more dangerous. I've talked to some top people in TCS and elsewhere, and they say that we are decades behind, forget about US, decades behind China. Our systems are very vulnerable. And these are realities, you know, these are realities today, how data is being collected to such an extent that I was told, by the way, this is just a little clue for you. If you want a private confidential conversation, it is better to use FaceTime than to use your normal phone. FaceTime audio, FaceTime video is difficult to encrypt, but your normal phone, anybody can be targeting you, or if you mention some keywords, it'll be picked up. In fact, aaj hum log jo baat kar rahe hain, pata nahi kahan ke satellite se hamari awaaz aaj kahin se record ho rahi hai. So we have to be highly aware of this. And I think Tarun ji has flagged some extremely important things, extremely important. And we have to evolve an entire strategy. Abhi jo hum dekh rahe hain, we feel that the government is very conciliatory. You know, we don't want to be seen as being too harsh because we are the world's largest democracy. Whereas China has, we don't want to be like Chinese. By the way, I do not want India to have China envy. China envy is a mistake, both strategically and civilizationally. Forget about politically. We are a democracy. They have moved against a Hong Kong paper. Sabko arrest kar diya, called Apple. That paper has increased its production because the Hong Kong people are so strong. 5 lakh circulation ho gayi. Please read about it. We don't want to do this, but we need strategic thinking, and people like Tarun Vijayji should evolve or guide. There should be a task force ki isko tackle kaise kiya jaye, because the West is now, you see the bans on Huawei. They are because of this only. They have been spying, collecting prototypes, and most of China's economic prosperity is based on copying, patent violation, intellectual property rights violation. So please think about all this. But now I invite both Tarun Vijayji and Bhatt Saab to respond. Go ahead.
No, just a moment. One thing I would like to say, what Anuradha said perfectly. What are the Indians doing in IITs? सुंदर पिचाई वहां पे गूगल में चले जाते हैं तो हम दुनिया भर में झंडे उठा लेते हैं. हमारा हिंदुस्तानी वहां चला गया, हमारा हिंदुस्तानी वहां चला गया. व्हाट हैज ही डन फॉर इंडिया और द इंडियंस? हैज ही ट्राइड टू क्रिएट अ प्लेटफॉर्म लाइक गूगल इन इंडिया एंड फॉर द इंडियंस? दैट वुड मेक मी हैप्पी टू सी दैट पिचाई इज हेल्पिंग इंडिया. और हूएवर गोज टू माइक्रोसॉफ्ट, दे आर द इंडियन कूलीज. द ईस्ट इंडियन इंडिया कंपनी ऑल्सो टुक अ लॉट ऑफ इंडियंस टू वर्क फॉर देम. They are born, they are the children of Bharat Mata, but they are working for American Mata. Why should I be happy about it? Let the Indians create a platform. And I must request Makranji that let your webinar pass a resolution that the government must create a separate Ministry of Cyber Affairs immediately. Cyber security is as important as Navy, Air Force, and Army. It's as important. The next war, we are already, China is fighting a cyber war against many, many countries. What are we doing? We are nowhere in the list of artificial intelligence countries. And we are going to fight, China is going to the number one, or the Israel. How much Israel can help us? So these are the things that we have to do, and nobody else is going to help us. I must quote one of the great intellectuals who said that we are good individually. We fight good individually, but we fail collectively. आप राजस्थान के इतिहास देख लीजिए, बाकी दुखद इतिहास है, बहुत अच्छे थे. गोवा में 400 साल हम पे गुलामी रही, 400 साल, मजाक बात है. तो ये चीज हमारे आईटीज, हमारे आईटी के जो शूरवीर हैं उनको पूछना चाहिए कि हिंदुस्तान में अपना प्लेटफॉर्म हो, अनुराधा ने ठीक कहा, अपने गूगल, अपने ट्विटर, अपने फेसबुक हम अपने बनाए, हिंदुस्तान के डाटा चोरी का हम अनुमति नहीं दे, हिंदुस्तान का डाटा हमारी संपत्ति है और हिंदुस्तान का डाटा हिंदुस्तान में रहना चाहिए, और एक सेपरेट मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइबर अफेयर, ये कोई छोटा डिपार्टमेंट नहीं है म्युनिसिपैलिटी का कि आप वो आईटी को दे दिया, आप किसी को दे दे, इसके लिए सेपरेट मिनिस्ट्री और एक्सपर्ट्स आने चाहिए। थैंक यू।
भट्ट साहब, विल यू रिस्पॉन्ड टू द डिफरेंस बिटवीन स्व एंड आत्मा इन द आत्मनिर्भर आइडिया, एंड देन रतन शारदा जी हैज ऑल्सो रेज दिस हैंड, we'll come back to this topic. I think we probably need a separate seminar on this, Tarun Vijay ji, and with I can talk to you about it next time we are together. Let us have a seminar on cyber security and bring in the real experts who might be able to guide us. It's a very serious matter. As I said in my private discussions with some people both here and abroad, they have told me that the threat is so large that, and we are so far behind that, you know, we are very vulnerable. Khair, and the only one thing I want to say with due respect, Tarun Vijay ji, this country, despite 73, 4 years of independence, we have no mechanisms of nurturing our talent. Really, somebody asked me how to keep our best people here. And then they, you know, what the government has done, they've, you know, brought in some fellowships, as if bringing in fellowships, kuch paisa aap dal denge, wo to paisa aapko bahut zyada wahan milega than here. The fact is, our ecosystem is very faulty. We are a great talent destroying system. You know, it is like the kiss of death, the poison chalice. You know, any place you go in India, especially government, semi-government, most of our energy is in pulling down people, in destroying talent, pushing people out. And, you know, you go around, you will see in institution after institution, we are declining. And if you let education slip, you know, and these are institutions where we have invested crores and crores of rupees. Look at my university, JNU. Kya halat hai? 1,000 acres of land in the heart of Delhi. Can you imagine its real estate worth? I'm just giving you an example. Kya hua hai wahan? At state expense, you have created anti-nationals. Matlab, aap unko paisa bhi denge, aur they are doing desh ki barbadi ke sazish. Aur ab hum badalne ki koshish kar rahe hain. Where are we? We are far away because our systems are defective. And this is another debate. But I'm saying that we cannot simply blame the Nadellas of the world or the Pichais of the world. Or, in fact, IBM head is also Indian. You know, the top techies are Indian, and inse hume benefit bhi milta hai. We cannot call them deshdrohis. Nahi to ye bhi khatam ho jayega. Jo humare liye kar rahe hain, wo bhi khatam kar denge hum. I think we have to respect them, work with them. And when we create, this is a market system, you know. If our systems are better, everyone will come here. Aisa koi cheez nahi hai ki they have some special love or affection or dedication or loyalty. But idhar aap kaam karne ki koshish kare, you try to start up a business, there are 69,000 clearances, state and center combined kiya agar aapne. I can give you the statistics. You know, my wife is trying to close a company, and for 4 years she has been struggling. You have to show you have no employees, you have not made profit. 4 saal se she's filing. She's fed up. She says, I'll never start another company because isme mera anubhav, ek to main fail ho gayi, within quotes. I don't want to say negative things about my wife. I'm saying that, you know, she had a food startup. It didn't work, whatever the reason is. Now she should be allowed to exit. She has no employees. A balance sheet is clean. Lekin hoi nahi pa raha hai. So I'm saying the complexity of the issue is much larger. But Bhatt Saab, can you enlighten about Sva and Atma in Atmanirbhar? Is there any difference? And then Dr. Ratan Sharda ji.
These are two cognate terms. And in a ordinary language, we use them as synonyms. But if we go to their etymological derivations and classical usage, then we find that they have different connotations. Sw stands for one's own, and therefore it may slip into a sort of contrast with par that needs to be avoided. So this sw par bhed is to be taken note of, and sw should be therefore expounded, as I said earlier, as sarv. Otherwise, sarv may lead to this aham, this sw may lead to some sort of egocentricity, and therefore it is to be used with judicious care. But the term atma stands for the totality. As I quoted Upanishad, etat atma idam sarvam. So atma stands for the paramatma also. There is no distinction between atma and paramatma in classical language, and therefore a better word is atma, so that it is not misunderstood or not distorted. But so also has its own significance. Both the, with judicious care you have to use the word so. But I believe that sw has also been used by the Vedic rishis, and they have used it in a wide sense, not in a limited sense. And always they talk of the entire cosmos, the whole
universe. You know, even with Atma, in order to differentiate, they say Paramatma and Jivatma. Actually, the Atma Tattva is Ishavasyam. It is all pervading. But
all pervading.
Because our experience as embodied beings makes us identify, then we think that my Atma is different from your Atma, but that's not the case. It's Atma is all pervading. Anyhow, see, you know, beautifully, I want to say one thing, if Tarunji is still with us. This discussion is also going on at two levels, you see. You know, Atma level also we are talking just now. And we are also talking at the level of, you know, the political, digital decolonization. This is the beauty of the Sanatana, that at one level we talk about the highest reality, you know, which is transcendental, which has nothing to do with time, space, geography, history, politics. And at another level, we are right now, here and now, talking about this very digital platform. So you see, this is the beauty of our discursivity. You know, it is like a ladder of consciousness. Ek sopan hai. Iske upar bhi hum ja sakte hain aur niche bhi aa sakte hain. You know, and itne hum swachhand hai yahan pe ye samvad mein. But I think,
in fact, please, when we talk of globalization, well, always we talk of spiritual globalization and not economic or monetary globalization. And in that globalization, there is no bulldozing of the differences, because we believe that differences provide richness and variety. And therefore, in globalization also, that multiplicity is to be taken care of and is to be assimilated in a oneness. That is our understanding. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. That is why I said the China model doesn't suit us, the bulldozing model. Anyhow, go ahead, Dr. Ratan Sharda ji, please.
Namaskar, Makran ji. Dhanyavad, mujhe mauka dene ka. सबसे पहले उनको धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ. ऐसा नहीं कि इतिहास हमें जानते नहीं, लेकिन जब तरुण जी जैसा कोई मन से, संताप से और भावुकता के साथ में विषय बताता है तो उससे प्रेरणा भी मिलती है और मन दुखता भी है, बहुत संताप होता है. इतने वर्ष हमारी सरकार, जिसको हम कह सकते हैं कि बड़ा लेबल है कि हिंदुत्ववादी है या नेशनलिस्ट है, उसके बावजूद अगर ये चीज आज भी पेंडिंग है, अभी अरुण जी जिस स्थान पर है उस पर काम कर रहे हैं, बड़ी खुशी की बात है। एक बात शायद कुछ लोगों को पता नहीं है कि ASI आगा खान से पैसे ले सकते हैं, तो जब लोग उदाहरण देते हैं कि मुगल जो मेमोरियल है बड़े अच्छी कंडीशन में है, तो उसके फंड आगा खान देते हैं ट्रस्ट, लेकिन हिंदू मेमोरियल छोड़िए, भारतीय मेमोरियल कहें हम आ गए, तो सारे भारतीय मेमोरियल के लिए बाहर से फंडिंग का कोई प्रावधान नहीं है, ऐसा मैंने सुना है। सच है कि झूठ है मैं नहीं जानता। अब मैं IT पे आता हूँ। मैंने 1994-95 में अपने स्मॉल स्केल टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री छोड़ के मैंने IT में पदार्पण किया था। मेरा IT से कोई संबंध नहीं था, मैं सब सीखा और सीखते समय मुझे ध्यान में आया कि सॉफ्टवेयर इंडस्ट्री के अंदर नैसकॉम जो सबसे बड़ी संस्था है उसके सिर पे जो बैठे हैं सारे मल्टीनेशनल कॉरपोरेशन है जो बाहर की कंपनियों के लिए लेबर करते हैं। अब ये मल्टीनेशनल कॉरपोरेशन जो बाहर के लिए लेबर करते हैं, जो उनके लिए फीस है, वो फीस स्ट्रक्चर ऐसा है कि छोटा मोटा सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलपर उसमें जा ही नहीं सकता। हमने कोशिश की छोटा एक संगठन बनाने की, नेचुरली वी हैड नो रिसोर्स, हमारे पास समय हम ज्यादा कर नहीं पाए, लेकिन उस समय मैंने देखा कि सारी सारी बड़ी कंपनियां केवल ह्यूमन आउटसोर्सिंग, जिसको कहते हैं लेबर आर्बिट्राज या जिसको हम गंदी भाषा में कहें तो साइबर पुलिस, इसका उन्होंने काम किया, अरबों रुपए कमाए, करोड़ों नहीं अरबों रुपए कमाए, अरबों कैश उनके थैलियों में पड़े हैं, उसके ऊपर सोते हैं, लेकिन कभी किसी मन में ये नहीं आया कि 100 करोड़ निकाल के दे दो नया OS बनाओ, 100 करोड़ दे दो नया विंडोज बनाएंगे, कभी नहीं किसी ने किया। छोटे मोटे प्रयत्न टाटा ने किए जो बंद कर दिए गए क्योंकि उसकी मार्केटिंग को ढंग से कर नहीं पाए। EX नाम का सॉफ्टवेयर था जिसलिए बंद किया कि उसके रेवेन्यू बाकी बड़े बड़े लेबर जॉब से बहुत कम थे। मानसिक हमारे बिग फाइव बिग टेन काम करेंगे कहाँ से अपेक्षा करें हमारे देश के अंदर कोई मॉडल खड़ा होगा। सरकार के पास तो बाद में जाएंगे, लेकिन हमारे लोग टेक्सटिंग दे रहे हैं, अरबों रुपए थे, उस पर काम हुआ नहीं। दूसरी बात, ये जो आप बात कर रहे हैं कि ये हमारे लोग बाहर बैठे, अच्छी बात है, लेकिन हम गूगल में सर्च करके देखिए, आप सवाल एक करेंगे उत्तर दूसरा है। मैं सुबह भी ट्राई कर चुका हूँ, मेरा काम है बैठता हूँ, मैं अपने सर्च करता हूँ, भी करता हूँ, लेकिन आप सवाल पूछिए उत्तर कुछ और आएगा। आप पूछिए मुस्लिम हिंदू के लिए, मुस्लिम एक रो के पास जाएगा। आप देखिए आश्चर्य होगा, राजस्थान की नेगेटिव रिपोर्टिंग जो न्यूज़पेपर में आ चुकी है वो आपको गूगल पे नहीं मिलती। ये आश्चर्य की बात होगी आपको। यही अगर ऐसे बाहर बैठे हमारे साथ जो अमेरिकन है, हम उनका गर्व है कि यहाँ से सीख कर गए, लेकिन उसके बाद अगर अपना जमीन और अपना ईमान वो बेच देते हैं तो मुझे उसके गौरव की मुझे गारंट नहीं है। अगर कमला हैरिस खुद को ये ब्राह्मण बोलती है और बाद में भारत की विरुद्ध बात करती है, मुझे उसमें गर्व नहीं है। एक झूठा गर्व हम लेना छोड़े, ये मेरा कहना है, और हमें अपने ही देश में करना पड़ेगा। IIT से निकलने वाले लोग, मेडिसिन करने वाले लोग, मेडिसिन वाले खुद की जमानत उनकी है कुछ, IIT से निकल वाले लोग जब वो बाहर जाते हैं क्यों नहीं उनके लिए बॉन्ड भरवाते कि आपने 5 साल हमारी सरकार के पैसे उपयोग, टैक्स पेयर के पैसे उपयोग किए, करोड़ रुपए आपको खर्च हुआ, आपके जब पैसे भेजेंगे तब आप फ्री होंगे, तब तक आप भारत सिटीजन, आपको इसकी ऊपर कुछ ये एक एक्साइजल बंधन होगा। हमें ऐसे कुछ करना पड़ेगा, देश के लिए गर्व जगाना संघ कर रहा है, आप लोग कर रहे हैं, लेकिन कुछ ना कुछ प्रैक्टिकल सोचना पड़ेगा, वरना यहाँ से सब्सिडाइज एजुकेशन में हम बाहर जाएंगे, JNU सब्सिडाइज लेकर एजुकेशन करेंगे, बाहर बैठे गुलाम बनेंगे और वहां से बड़ी प्रतिष्ठा प्राप्त कर बनेंगे। ये जो विशेष
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल किसी का माइक ऑन है, मैं आपसे दरख्वास्त करता हूँ कि आप अपना माइक म्यूट कर दीजिए, बोलेंगे तब अनम्यूट, क्योंकि बैकग्राउंड आवाज कहीं से आ रही है। भट्ट साहब आप भी, हाँ अब थोड़ा सा ठीक है, तो इसका जवाब कौन देना चाहेगा? मैं सिर्फ इतना कहूँगा क्योंकि मैं एक क्षेत्र से जुड़ा हूँ, जो हमारे आरक्षण लाभी छात्र हैं उनसे तो कोई फी ही नहीं लिए जाती, तो उनसे क्या बॉन्ड लेंगे आप? और दूसरे छात्रों से आप बॉन्ड की बात कर रहे हैं, बॉन्ड वापस एक मिनट में दे देंगे, पैसा कुछ ज्यादा नहीं है।
मैं पैसे नहीं मांग रहा, मैं कमिटमेंट मांग रहा हूँ भारत।
हाँ अब देखिए ना, मैं वही आपसे कह रहा हूँ कि कमिटमेंट जोर जबरदस्ती से तो नहीं होगी, उसमें प्रेरणा होनी चाहिए अंदर से। और मैं आपको, मैं विदेश में रहा हूँ, मैं उनमें से एक हूँ जो वापस आ गया, मेरे हाथ में PhD आई और मैं देश आया, क्योंकि मेरी बड़ी तमन्ना थी कि इस देश का मैं कुछ हिस्सा बनूं, यहाँ के लिए कुछ करूं। लेकिन मैंने जो कहा वो भी सच है कि यहाँ पे आप कुछ करने की कोशिश करेंगे, आपको इतना धक्का दिया जाएगा, पांव खींचे जाएंगे कि आप लगभग निराशा की पराकाष्ठा तक पहुंच जाएंगे, लेकिन कुछ अंदर एक चीज होती है जिसकी वजह से आपको बड़ा आनंद आएगा इस देश में काम करने के लिए। लेकिन मैं सिर्फ ये कहना चाह रहा हूँ कि वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चीज रतन जी, जो हमारे भारतीय लोग विदेश में, खास करके संपन्न देश में है, उन सब में इतना देश प्रेम है और इतना कुछ कर रहे हैं हमारे लिए कि हमारे यहाँ रहने वालों से ज्यादा कर रहे हैं। क्योंकि हम वर्ण तो छोड़िए, आश्रम की हम बात करते हैं, हमारे यहाँ लोभ छूटता नहीं है। आप कोई भी आदमी यहाँ देखिए, चाहे वो रिटायर्ड मेजर जनरल हो, कोई दूसरा आईएएस हो, सेक्रेटरी गवर्नमेंट, फॉरेन सेक्रेटरी, ये कभी पद नहीं छोड़ना चाहेंगे। कुछ बाद में मिले, कुछ बाद में मिले, पकड़े रहो। विदेश में वो नहीं है, वो सचमुच वानप्रस्थ में जाते हैं, ट्रस्ट खोलते हैं, अपनी यूनिवर्सिटी के लिए पैसा देते हैं, एक उदार भावना है, अपने गांव में स्कूल खोलते हैं। अब मेरे अपने नॉलेज में से कम 25 लोग हैं विदेश में जो 1 करोड़ से ज्यादा अनुदान अपने, जो अपनी स्कूल है, विलेज स्कूल है, उसमें वो देते हैं, किसी को खबर भी नहीं है, पता भी नहीं है। तो मैं ये कहना चाह रहा हूँ, हमारी व्यवस्था सुधारना बहुत जरूरी है, और व्यवस्था सुधर नहीं रही है। मैं एक बात कहना चाह रहा हूँ, इसका कारण यह है कि हमने यहाँ एक समझौता कर लिया है। जैसे तरुण विजय जी ने एक बात कही, वो एक गुलामत्व का निशान है, हमने समझौता कर लिया है, हमने दूसरी तरह से समझौता कर लिया। जैसे कहीं पानी टपक रहा है, नल का टूटा है, कहीं कूड़ा पड़ा है, हमने समझौता कर लिया है कि भारत में ऐसा ही होगा। निपुणता कहिए, योग्यता कहिए, ये हम अपेक्षा ही नहीं करते। पब्लिक सर्वेंट से तो छोड़िए, हम घरों में भी कहाँ हम सोचते हैं कि ये अच्छा करो, ये सबसे अच्छा करके दिखाओ। नहीं, स्लॉपीनेस, आप हर जगह जाइए और आपको यही, हमारा कल्चर ये हो गया। आप थाईलैंड जाइए, कितना नीट है, जो स्ट्रीट वेंडर है कितना साफ सुथरा है, ग्लव्स पहन के आपको देगा, पाइनएप्पल के लिए एक स्टिक देगा, आपको छूना नहीं पड़ेगा, कितना हाइजेनिक है, हर जगह कितनी नीटनेस है। छोटे छोटे देशों में, म्यांमार, श्रीलंका, आर्किटेक्चर कितना सुंदर है, व्यवस्था कितनी सुंदर है। हम दिल्ली में रहते हैं, सरकार चाहे बदले, पेवमेंट तोड़ेंगे बनाएंगे, तोड़ेंगे बनाएंगे, इट्स अ रैकेट, एवरीबडी नोज इट, एंड कोई पेवमेंट ठीक नहीं मिलेगी, कितना खर्चा हुआ है, बेशुमार। सो यू सी, हमारे भीतर ये इतना, अब बंबई में आप रहते हैं, एवरी ईयर इट्स फ्लड्स, डोंट यू थिंक वी हैव द इंटेलिजेंस टू क्लीन द ड्रेन्स? एवरी ईयर बॉम्बे इज फ्लडेड, फुल्ली फ्लडेड मुंबई, यू नो। एंड मैं छोटा था तब से मैं देख रहा हूं, मेरे रिलेटिव्स रहते हैं, मैं महाराष्ट्रियन हूं, आज भी वही हालत है। सरकार चाहे बदलती है, नहीं बदलती है। टू फ्यू इयर्स अगो अर्नब वेंट टू वन ऑफ दो स्टेशन, आई डोंट नो वेदर इट वाज कुर्ला और वेयर एवर, इट वाज कंप्लीटली सबमर्ज, द ट्रैक्स वर सबमर्ज, यू नो, इट्स अ शोशागिरी, तमाशा हुआ, आज भी फ्लडिंग चल रहा है। नाउ हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल? आई ऑलवेज से वी आर ऑल रिस्पॉन्सिबल। हम लोग क्या करते हैं, वी आर ऑलवेज वेटिंग टू ब्लेम समबडी कि इसकी जिम्मेदारी है। मैं कहता हूं आई एम रिस्पॉन्सिबल, आई स्टार्ट विद माई सेल्फ बिकॉज आई हैव एक्सेप्टेड दीज थिंग्स, यू नो, एंड लाइक मी मिलियंस हैव एक्सेप्टेड इट। समटाइम्स यू मे से दैट इट्स अ कोपिंग डिवाइस, बट रतन जी आई हैव नो एक्सक्यूज, मुझे सब कुछ मिला है जो एक मध्यम वर्गी को मिलना चाहिए। मेरे पास सब कुछ है, मुझे मुझे आज कंप्यूटर खरीदना है, मैं खरीद सकता हूँ। आई जस्ट गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल, मुझे कोई भी किताब खरीदनी हो मैं खरीद सकता हूँ। आई एम जस्ट सेइंग आई कैन नॉट ब्लेम एनी बडी टूडे, आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू, मैं इसलिए मैं कहना चाह रहा हूँ आई मस्ट स्टार्ट विथ माई सेल्फ, जो मेरे से हो, मुझे वैचारिक स्वराज्य हो, या आई ऑलवेज से आई एम सर्विंग भवानी भारती बिकॉज आई लाइक दैट वर्ड, भवानी भारती, श्री अरविंद का शब्द है, भवानी मंदिर से मैंने लिया है। तो सो आई वी हैव टू कल्टिवेट दैट एटीट्यूड। सो आई एम नॉट वरिड अबाउट IITs, आई एम नॉट वरिड अबाउट पीपल लीविंग इंडिया, बिकॉज यहाँ उनके लिए स्कोप बहुत कम है। वहां जाके अच्छा करते हैं एंड एवरी डे दे थिंक अबाउट इंडिया. उनकी न्यूज भी इंडिया की न्यूज है. आपको बताएंगे, मेरे कुछ फ्रेंड्स हैं, रिलेटिव्स हैं, वो मुझे फोन करके बताते हैं, भाई ये हो रहा है शिमला में. मैंने कहा मुझे तो पता नहीं है. इनफैक्ट द फनी थिंग वाज व्हेन आई वाज इन जेएनयू, पीपल वर टेलिंग मी आज वहां धरना है, डीन को सराउंड किया गया है. मैंने कहा बॉस मुझे बख्श दो, हर रोज की कहानी है ये, आप मुझे वहां से फोन करके पूछ रहे हो. तो व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज दैट आई एम वेरी होपफुल अबाउट इंडिया, बट वी हैव टू डू सम कोर्स करेक्शन. और सिस्टम की बात की आपने, इंडिविजुअल्स लुक एट आवर संगीत, यू नो वन पर्सन विल सिट इन फ्रंट एंड फॉर 4 hours ही कैन डू सम अमेजिंग राग, इनोवेटिव, nobody has heard it before. राग तो वही है, इतना करेंगे, इतने क्रिएटिव है. बट यहाँ आप वाद वृंद कभी सक्सीड नहीं हुआ, हम ऑर्केस्ट्रा बना ही नहीं पाए, बिकॉज हमारी संस्कृति बहुत इंडिविजुअलिस्टिक है. लेकिन हमें कलेक्टिविटी एंड कलेक्टिव वर्क करना सीखना चाहिए. यू नो इफ यू लिव अब्रॉड स्पेशली इन द ईस्ट, उनमें जो कन्फ्यूशनिज्म है वो एक बहुत कलेक्टिविटी पे जोर देता है. एंड आई वॉज इन सिंगापोर and what I learned is every person has to groom 4 or 5 successors, tabhi aapko successful mana jayega, ki aapko replace karne walon ko aapko khada karna hai. Yahan to forget about grooming your successor, second rung of leadership dikhaiye mujhe kahin bhi. Everywhere you want to destroy any competition, whether it's private sector, public sector, to kuch you know we have to change. And uske liye again I feel that wahi kuch atma sakshatkar hona zaruri hai. We have to lose our fear, ye jo dar hai ki koi mere se meri pratishtha chheen lega ya mera pad chheen lega ya mera bhavishya chheen lega, whatever it is we are afraid of, meri sanskriti chheen lega, ye desh khatam ho jayega. Ye desh kabhi nahi khatam hoga. I mean I am a very small person, but the people I respect, Swami Vivekananda said it, Aurobindo said it, I trust them. Apta Vachan. This culture will never be finished because we have something unique to offer. To hum wahan us confidence se hum bahar niklenge, to I think we become a confident nation. And wo I think jo vishwas badhega, swabhiman badhega aur hausla badhega aur usi tarah hum atmanirbhar bhi banenge. और धीरे धीरे ये काम होगा. आई थिंक वी मे नॉट, आई मे नॉट लिव टू सी दिस इंडिया ऑफ माई ड्रीम्स, आई डोंट नो, बट एटलीस्ट आई हैव टू क्रिएट इट इनसाइड मी, इन माई ओन हार्ट. नाउ वी आर कमिंग टू द एंड ऑफ आवर टाइम, इट्स अ संडे. आई एम वेरी ग्रेटफुल आपने अपना कीमती वक्त यहाँ हम लोगों के सत्संग में आके बिताया. मैं आप लोगों का बहुत आभारी हूँ. किसी को कुछ भी कहना हो 30 सेकंड के लिए, ओपन फोरम है हमारा, कुछ भी कहिए, आलोचना करनी है वो भी कहिए, आपको कोई भी चीज हमको कम्युनल बताना है वो भी कह सकते हैं, नो प्रॉब्लम, जो मन में आए कह लीजिए फॉर 30 seconds. एंड देन आई विल इनवाइट राजवीर जी टू से अ फ्यू वर्ड्स एंड देन माधव हाड़ा साहब विल डिलीवर द वोट ऑफ थैंक्स ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूट. ही रिप्रेजेंट्स द फेलोज जस्ट नाउ. सो प्लीज द इट्स एन ओपन फोरम, किसी को कुछ भी कहना हो प्लीज कह दीजिए, बट ब्रीफली. Go ahead. कोई सवाल पूछना हो या कुछ भी कहना हो, कुछ पूछना हो, प्लीज आप कह सकते हैं.
सर मैं कुछ बोल सकता हूँ?
सर मैं आपको दो उदाहरण देना चाहूंगा. मैंने भी क्रिप्टो करेंसी, आप साइबर सिक्योरिटी की बात करते हैं वगैरह वगैरह, और उसके मैंने टैग हमारे मिनिस्टर्स को भी किए और कुछ उसका असर भी हुआ, लेकिन गवर्नमेंट तक हुआ मुझे पता नहीं, लेकिन ऐसे कार्यक्रम किए. मैं जहाँ रहता हूँ सामने प्लेट है, मैं 2 साल से यहाँ के MLA, यहाँ के कॉर्पोरेटर सबको मैं प्रार्थना कर चुका हूँ कि पवेले को हम तो साफ कर नहीं सकते, वीड्स हैं. बार बार प्रार्थना करने के बाद मैंने पर्सनल एक फोटो भेजी जिसमें 2/3 ऑफ पवेले वाज कवर्ड बाय वीड्स. किसी ने जवाब नहीं दिया, ना महाराष्ट्र सरकार के मिनिस्टर ने, ना MLA ने, MP ने. और मैंने यहाँ तक कहा कि मुझे फर्क नहीं पड़ता कि ये बीजेपी के हैं, शिवसेना के हैं, लेकिन इस कॉरपोरेशन को अगली बार मैं वोट नहीं दूंगा। 32 साल से कांग्रेस मुक्त हुई है, अगर उसके बावजूद आप ये किसी और के डालना चाहते हैं, बड़ी दयनीय अवस्था है। तो जो आपने कहा कि हम प्रयत्न करते हैं, क्या हम कर सकते हैं, करते हैं, लेकिन जिनको हम चुन के भेजते हैं उनकी जिम्मेवारी उनको भी समझनी होगी। और जैसे मैंने कहा, अगर हमारे घर की कंपनियां अगर पैसे ऐसे देश के लिए नहीं लगा सकती, इन्वेस्ट कर सकती, हमारे टेक्निकल स्टार्टअप्स को चीन और अमेरिका से पैसे आते हैं, हमारे भारतीय फंड मैनेजर उनको पैसे नहीं देते। और अगर कोई देता, आपको आश्चर्य होगा, एक ऐसा बहुत बड़ा प्रतिष्ठित नाम है, लूंगा नहीं, जो केवल एक किसी स्टार्टअप को 10 लाख देता है, बोलता है मेरा नाम उपयोग करो और तुमको करोड़ों मिल जाएंगे। तो ऐसे वातावरण में अगर जो संपन्न समाज है वह देश के लिए नहीं सोचता, उसको भी प्रेरणा देने की आवश्यकता है, जो हमारे जैसे आम नागरिक को तो आवश्यकता है ही। तो यह सोच बदलने के लिए हम बहुत साल से काम कर रहे हैं, लेकिन जैसे आपने कहा शुरुआत हुई है, अभी भी बहुत काम बाकी।
जी बहुत धन्यवाद। मैं आपको दो उदाहरण देना चाहता हूँ स्टार्टअप को लेके। हमने एक बजवर्ड बनाया है, 100 में से 1-2 स्टार्टअप ही सफल होंगे, और सरकार पैसे भी देते हैं। जैसे JNU में उन्होंने ये मुहिम शुरू की, IITs जैसी, कि आपको 15 लाख रुपया मिलेगा अगर आपके पास स्टार्टअप आइडिया है। तो जो मैंने पाया, मैं किसी यूनिवर्सिटी का नाम नहीं लूंगा, मेरी अपनी का तो बिल्कुल नहीं, मैं ऑलरेडी अनपॉपुलर हो चुका हूँ, लेकिन कई लोगों ने 15 लाख का ग्रांट ले लिया। उन्होंने तो ग्रांट समझ लिया इसको, और जब फेलियर रेट 99% या 97% है, ये तो एक दिस इज व्हाट वी आर। जो असली स्टार्टअप करना चाह रहा है, जिसके पास आइडिया है, उसको शायद पैसा नहीं मिलेगा। जो वेल कनेक्टेड है उसको 10-15 लाख रुपए मिल जाएंगे। यू डोंट हैव टू बी अ नीरव मोदी टू स्टील 13,000 crores, यू कैन सो टू स्पीक स्टील 15 लाख्स, वो भी ठीक है। सो यू नो स्टील, आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू ऑफेंड एनी बॉडी, मेनी आर माई फ्रेंड्स, बट यही है, इसमें कोई आउटपुट नहीं आएगा ज्यादा। अच्छा, कल एक बहुत अच्छी बात निकली हमारे IIT मद्रास के। IIT मद्रास हैज बाय द वे वन ऑफ द बेस्ट, ये जो टेक पार्क होता है, रिसर्च पार्क, आई हैव गॉन देयर, इट्स मॉडल लाइक अ सिंगापुर टेक पार्क। मेनी टॉप industries have their offices. That's a very successful model. They've used their real estate and it's fully funded by this partnership. So one of our top electrical engineering professors, Shripad Kalmalkar ji, he explained how we are unable to make a chip in India. We are unable to make a diode. Ye jo remote control hai, isme diode hota hai. Ye hum abhi India mein nahi bana paaye. To uski wajah unhone samjhai ke ये वेरी सोफिस्टिकेटेड मटेरियल होता है, बहुत प्योर होना पड़ता है, एंड इसके लिए किस तरह की इन्वेस्टमेंट चाहिए जो वो इकोनॉमिकली वायबल हो, एंड वी हैव नॉट बीन एबल टू मेक अ चिप इन इंडिया। सॉफ्टवेयर इज नथिंग बट मैन पावर एक्सपोर्ट, जो आपने कहा, वी एक्सपोर्ट ब्रेन्स, हम लोग दूसरे के हायर्ड ब्रेन्स बने हैं फ्रेंकली। और मैं आपको एक चीज बताना चाहता हूँ, एंटी अंग्रेजी भी कुछ मूवमेंट चल रही है, और मैंने सर संघचालक जी से पूछा, इन्होंने कहा हटाओ नहीं लाओ, हिंदी लाओ, संस्कृत लाओ, डोंट से हटाओ। व्हेन आई वेंट टू ब्राजील, दे टोल्ड मी इंडियन प्रोग्रामर्स हैव एन एडवांटेज। आई आस्क्ड देम व्हाई, ही सेड बिकॉज दे नो इंग्लिश। सारे कोड तो कंप्यूटर लैंग्वेज में लिखते, इंस्ट्रक्शन अंग्रेजी में लिखी जाती है। We have succeeded partly because we know English. So, hum unke cyber coolie ban paaye because the industry is controlled by these people, and we are able to read the instructions. Adobe ke instructions hote hain. So, all I'm saying is the world is more complicated than we think. And abhi Quad and G7+4 vagara, we need these alliances. And I think manthan jo hum log kar rahe hain, hum to buddhijeevi hain. हम यही कर सकते हैं। एंड योर फ्रस्ट्रेशन आई हैव शेयर्ड, JNU के सामने एक बहुत बड़ा मॉल है, उसके आगे कचरा है, मैंने फोटो लिया उसका, और आपके काउंसलर थे, उनको फोटो भेज दिया। बाय द वे दिस, आई गॉट एन इमीडिएट रिप्लाई ऑन ट्वीट, और एक हफ्ता वो साफ रहा, फिर मैं शिमला आया, दोबारा गया, सेम थिंग, अब कचरा वहां पड़ा है। सो यू आर एब्सोल्युटली राइट, elections, elected representatives, Tarun Vijay ji ne kaha parliamentary democracy, Gandhi ji ne kaha tha as a sign of our slavery, we don't know ke achhi governance kahan se aayegi, it's a problem because our entire energy is to remain in power. You'll see Chinese leaders are never seen. They don't make public statements. They are invisible. And they are not insecure. Normally, you know, 3 years, 4 years, aisa nahi hota. There's a meritocracy of sorts within the Communist Party, you know. तो उनकी एनर्जी गवर्नेंस में जाती है ज्यादा, हमारी एनर्जी सिर्फ ये फेंडिंग ऑफ अटैक्स ये वो. सो आई थिंक आवर लीडर्स आर फार मोर कॉम्पिटेंट इन द सेंस आई हैव रिस्पेक्ट फॉर द पॉलिटिकल क्लास बिकॉज इतना मुश्किल काम करते हैं वो, इतना मुश्किल काम, डे एंड नाइट दे आर अंडर अटैक. एंड सो इट्स अ कॉम्प्लेक्स सिचुएशन. बट द लास्ट थिंग आई वॉन्टेड टू से वॉज दिस. You know, I go back to the great example of Shivaji and Samarth Ramdas. So Ramdas was a guide to Shivaji. Samse Tukaram also had met Shivaji. But Shivaji ka coronation ho gaya aur Raigad mein unka ek bhavya wo kila ban raha tha, Raj Mahal bhi ban raha tha. Aur sare log wahan kaam kar rahe the. Tab Samarth Ramdas Shivaji ke साथ साथ देख रहे थे, काम का निरीक्षण कर रहे थे. तो शिवाजी के मन में एकदम ये भावना जगी कि मैंने कितना मुश्किल काम कर दिया, हिंदवी स्वराज यू नो का स्थापन मैंने कर दिया, कितनी मुश्किलें उन्होंने सही. वी ऑल नो ही वॉज इन औरंगजेब कोर्ट, हाउ ही वहां से पसार कैसे हुए, इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ लेजेंड. वी हर्ड अबाउट अफजल खान विद द nails, you know, how he was able to overcome Afzal Khan, who was a very big, very powerful man. He was a very huge man. Wo vaghini to nakh, they say, wo usse unhone, aur unke paas wo khanjar tha, vagara, vagara. And he picked up his thought. Samarth Guru Ramdas picked up Shivaji's thought. And unhone, he pointed to one chipkali, you know, one lizard was in the crack of the wall, underneath, niche. He just said, Did you notice this? तो मैं ये कहना चाह रहा हूँ, इसमें बहुत गूढ़ रहस्य है. हम तो कुछ नहीं है, यू नो, एक लहर, बहुत बड़ी लहर होती है, उसके लहर के ऊपर एक तिनका उछलता है. तिनका लहर नहीं बनाता, लहर तिनके को उछालती है. वी आर ऑल लाइक दैट. तो बहुत बड़ी लहर चल पड़ी है जिसमें आई फील सनातन धर्म जो है, वॉट एवर वी से, उसकी अवेकनिंग पार्ट वन तो हो चुका था ड्यूरिंग ब्रिटिश साम्राज्य ने, तो हम उनको निकाल नहीं पाते. नाउ ये पार्ट टू है जो मैं समझ रहा हूँ. एंड सडनली थिंग्स आर अनुकूल, परिस्थितियां आ रही है और आई भी है. एंड इसमें हमें क्या काम करना है इंडिविजुअली कलेक्टिवली, इस पे हमें सोचना चाहिए. बिकॉज आई थिंक इवन इफ शर्विन का एक बहुत बढ़िया लेख है द आवर ऑफ गॉड, तो वो कहते हैं आवर ऑफ गॉड जब आता है थोड़े काम से भी बहुत श्रेय हम प्राप्त कर सकते हैं. और दूसरा टाइम ऐसा होता है आप कितनी भी मेहनत करो श्रेय कम मिलता है. तो इस आशावादी कुछ शब्दों के साथ आई विल इनवाइट फर्स्ट राजवीर जी टू से अ फ्यू वर्ड्स. ही इज आवर सीनियर, ही इज राइट नाउ आवर सीनियर मोस्ट फेलो. He has just finished his term, and this is his, should I say, his moment of climax at the institute. Itna badhiya inhone ayojan kiya hai. I think we've not had such a conference for a very long time. So inspiring, full of so many different voices, and I think it's a lasting legacy. I hope this becomes a book. I also use this occasion to invite you. From tomorrow, we are so busy, Ratanji. I can't tell you. अभी हमने International Yoga Day किया, अभी इसको समाप्त कर रहे हैं और कल हम कश्मीर शैव दर्शन पे अभिनव गुप्त पे हम कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रहे हैं. And you are most humbly invited to join. I think शैव दर्शन, कश्मीर त्रिक दर्शन is such a magnificent philosophy about which most people in India know very little. It is so empowering. It is so empowering because it shows you that you're none other than Shiva. And it does so in a wonderful way, in an aesthetic way also. Anyhow, so we are very busy, but kehne ka matlab ye hai ke hum log today is Sunday, the institute, despite COVID, has been so busy. And that is why I'm saying ek energy aisi chal rahi hai. So Rajveer ji, this is his finest moment, I think. He's done a wonderful work on Kautilya. We are very proud of it. We'll be publishing it. In fact, Sage has agreed to publish this. So I congratulate you, sir. You have succeeded in this really great research work, which one of the top publishers of the world is publishing with us, with IIAS. And now you're going on a very high note. Going meaning coming back to IIS, I would say, because we never say going. But you've finished your tenure on a very high note as the convener of this seminar. So I invite you to say a few words, and then Hara Saab will give a vote of thanks.
Sorry, I'm saying I must thank the director, Professor Pranjupe, for always inspiring me and guiding me all as well. The work that I have produced on Kautilya is a combination of the contribution of my other fellows, and mostly I must express my thanks to Professor Pranjupe for his comments, for his guide, and so many other things. In the last 3 days, in fact, the deliberations have been so enlightening and so illuminating, so informative, that each one of us at least must have learned something or the other. In fact, for me, so far as the Swaraj in Ideas is concerned, basically, I can say that it has rather three connotations or meanings. One, that we must, for Atmanirbhar Bharat and for Swaraj in Ideas, we must develop self-confidence. In fact, Swaraj means confidence in the self. And until unless we have the confidence in the self, we cannot talk of any Vaicharik Swaraj. We look always towards the stamp from outside. If some foreigner says it's a very good work you have done, and if Professor Pranjupe says it's a very good work done, perhaps we will tend to believe, oh, what a great scholar, such and such foreigner has said so. Are, why can't we say that Professor Makarand Pranjupe has said so? Why should we go beyond our boundaries to get a certificate? If we have done some work with adequate data, with adequate research, with original research, then we must say that this is, of course, true what I am saying. And I must quote that data. I must give the praman, proof. Fine enough. Then what others say, what foreigners say, why should I be bothered about it? And self-confidence, it is in fact the self-confidence and the creative research which has brought us at par with many medicinal kind of knowledge or branches. हम अपनी अपनी जो मेडिसिनल नॉलेज है उसको क्यों नकार रहे हैं? अगर बाबा रामदेव कुछ कहते हैं कोरोनिल अच्छा है तो उसको तो कहते हैं नहीं नहीं ये तो बिल्कुल धोखेबाजी है, और अगर कोई और बाहर से कर दे तो वो बहुत अच्छा है. विदाउट अंटिल अनलेस वी हैव सम काइंड ऑफ ए डेटा टू से दैट नो व्हाट एवर हैज बीन डन बाय बाबा रामदेव इज नॉट राइट. We must produce the data. We must produce, corroborate our what we are saying. So therefore, self-condemnation and self-criticism are two different things. I have no objection in self-criticism, criticizing the self, correcting the self, but I don't believe in self-condemnation. So therefore, be proud of what you have. That does not mean that we are not prepared to learn from outside. बहुत तीनों दिनों में ये एक क्रक्स निकल के आया मिस्टर चेयरमैन कि let the windows be open. But for that we should not demolish our walls. कल शायद रतन सादा जी ने ये बात कही थी कि हम अपनी खिड़की खोलें, लेकिन उसके लिए अपना घर गिराना जरूरी थोड़ी नहीं है. द therefore, I am saying it has been a very enriching kind of experience for me. The three very well-known scholars who spoke today, they in fact covered a wide range of ideas and wide range of issues. Professor Makarand Pranjupe, in fact, is an encyclopedic personality. And therefore, today, though he was a chair, but I in fact treat him always as a person who has been very actively participating in analyzing, in proposing, in examining, and presenting a synthesized kind of a view. Professor S.R. Bhatt gave a very comprehensive talk today, touching on various aspects of the meaning of Swaraj in ideas. And he, in fact, was very right. One word which he spoke and liked by many of us is dharmocracy. And in fact, in India, it is not today that we are talking of dharmocracy. Even in Kautilya Arthashastra, we come across this dharmocracy. And we find that Kautilya was saying that there has been some kind of a wedding between earth and dharma. And therefore, if it has to be a wedding between dharma and earth, it is nothing but a dharmocracy. So therefore, this is what Professor Bhatt, in fact, took us to. And therefore, we are thankful to Professor Bhatt. And one thing which he said is that we want ekatmata, not ekrupta. That has been our philosophy. And that is what we have learned today, that we must work for ekatmata, may not be ekrupta. And that has never been a part of our thinking. हम तो ये कहते हैं कि सभी लोग सुखी रहें, को एग्जिस्टेंस में बिलीव करते हैं, हम रिप्लेसमेंट में बिलीव नहीं करते हैं. मुझे लगता है कल लावण्यानी जी ने जो बात कही, मुझे तो बहुत अच्छी लगी कि वी बिलीव इन को एग्जिस्टेंस, नॉट रिप्लेसमेंट. एंड देयरफॉर वी वांट टू को एग्जिस्ट विद अदर्स, वी डोंट वांट टू रिप्लेस अदर्स. एंड सिमिलरली वी वांट अदर्स आल्सो टू ट्रीट अस like this. And another thing which I would say was the talk by Tarun Vijay. Itna uttejak aur vicharottejak informative talk Tarun ji ne diya. Bahut sari cheeze jo humko nahi malum thi. Kai baar hum darte hain ki agar humne apne bhartiyon bhartiya heroes ko kahin par place de diya to pata nahi kya bhuchal aa jayega. Aur aa bhi jata hai, bhuchal aa jata hai. अगर हमने एक नाम बदल दिया, अगर हमने कोई नाम रख दिया औरंगजेब से हटा करके, तो भूचाल आ गया. माने जो मानसिक दास्ता है, उस मानसिक दास्ता को हम इतना उनकी जकड़ में आ चुके हैं, द मोमेंट वी ट्राई टू मूव अवे, देन वी आर टैग्ड विद सम और द अदर काइंड ऑफ ए टाइटल. वी मस्ट नॉट बी अफ्रेड ऑफ दैट. We must follow the truth. India ka bhi worship karna seekhein. Ye hamare vaicharik swarajya ka shayad essence hoga. Lekin jab hum India ko poojte hain, to hum kisi ko kill nahi karte hain. Hum ye nahi kehte ki nahi America galat hai. We are saying we are proud of what we have. We don't say that we are condemning what America has. और द वेस्ट है. अभी मैं कई बार कहता हूं अपनी बात में कि हमारे यहां तो सब ये कहते रहे, इवन आरएसएस भी ये कहता रहा है कि जो अपना है उसको युगानुकूल बनाओ और जो बाहर का है उसे देशानुकूल बनाओ, अंधाकुरण मत करो. आई थिंक देयर इज नो हार्म इन दिस, इज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट काइंड ऑफ ए फिलोसफी. सो सर, दिस वॉज अ वेरी एनलाइटनिंग एक्सपीरियंस फॉर मी. And I must thank all the participants and paper presenters who came here at our request. We hope that they will continue to support us in future also in whatever endeavors we make towards that direction. Thank you so much.
सम्माननीय निदेशक जी और आज के मुख्य वक्ता सम्माननीय तरुण विजय जी, भट्ट साहब, रतन शारदा जी और हमारे इस संगोष्ठी के संयोजक माननीय राजवीर जी, दरअसल दो दिनों तक मुझे एक बात बराबर स्मरण में रही और मैं वो कल भी कहना चाहता था और आज भी कहना चाहता हूँ। महात्मा गांधी ने हिंद स्वराज में एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण बात कही थी कि हमको बाघ नहीं चाहिए, बाघ का स्वभाव तो चाहिए। और हमने संस्थान ने इस बाघ के स्वभाव की विदाई का मुहिम शुरू की है। मैं सम्माननीय निदेशक जी और प्रोफेसर राजवीर जी को इसके लिए बधाई देता हूँ। बाघ का स्वभाव जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा कुछ भी अर्थपूर्ण होगा इसकी गुंजाइश बहुत कम है। और सम्माननीय निदेशक जी ने और राजवीर जी ने इसकी पहल की और मैं आज यहाँ आप सभी सहभागी मित्रों से एक बात साझा करना चाहता हूँ। संस्थान निरंतर सक्रिय है, कोरोना की इस आपदा के बावजूद भी एक दिन ऐसा नहीं रहा हो जब संस्थान अध्येताओं के लिए बंद हुआ हो। हम निरंतर अवकाश के दिनों में भी जा रहे हैं और बराबर काम कर रहे हैं। संस्थान की गतिविधियां भी निरंतर हो रही है, ये अलग बात है कि अब ऑनलाइन होने लगी है, लेकिन ऐसा कोई महीना नहीं गया जब हमारे यहाँ कोई गतिविधि या आयोजन नहीं हुआ हो। मैं आपको आश्वस्त करना चाहता हूं कि संस्थान निरंतर सक्रिय है माननीय निदेशक जी के नेतृत्व में और उसके जो बुनियादी संकल्प हैं उनको फलीभूत करने के लिए हम सभी प्रयत्नशील हैं। मैं इन तीन दिनों में जो सत्र वक्ता आए विभिन्न सत्रों में, उन सब के प्रति अध्येता परिषद की ओर से कृतज्ञता ज्ञापित करता हूँ। मैं इस सेमिनार को आयोजित करने के लिए, इस विषय का प्रस्ताव करने के लिए सम्माननीय राजवीर जी, जिनका कार्यकाल अब पूरा हुआ है और जो मुझे लगता है कि बहुत महत्वपूर्ण काम करके यहाँ से जा रहे हैं, उनके प्रति भी सभी अध्येताओं के प्रति कृतज्ञता ज्ञापित करता हूँ। मैं सम्माननीय निदेशक जी के प्रति हृदय से कृतज्ञ हूँ कि वे निरंतर इस तरह की गतिविधियों को प्रोत्साहित करते हैं, निरंतर इस तरह की गतिविधियों के लिए पहल के लिए स्वतंत्रता देते हैं। कल से फिर हम एक सेमिनार कर रहे हैं जिसका नेतृत्व हमारी अध्येता डॉक्टर अलका त्यागी करेंगी और मैं आप सभी मित्रों से, सहभागी मित्रों से अनुरोध करता हूं कि आप उसमें सहभागी बने। मैं एक बार सभी वक्ताओं के प्रति, सभी सहभागी मित्रों के प्रति अध्येताओं की ओर से हृदय से कृतज्ञता ज्ञापित करता हूं और माननीय निदेशक जी को धन्यवाद देता हूं। धन्यवाद,
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। अपना प्रिंटेड पेपर, रिटन पेपर भेज दीजिएगा, हम छापना चाहेंगे और राजवीर जी इसके संपादक होंगे। अगर मुझे समय मिला तो मैं सह संपादक का भी योगदान करने को तैयार हूँ क्योंकि विषय इतना महत्वपूर्ण है। और आखिर में अलका जी, आप दो शब्द अभिनव गुप्त के बारे में दो शब्द कह दीजिए, कल से हम शुरुआत कर रहे हैं फिर हम समाप्त करते हैं, आप दो शब्द कह दीजिए।
सबको प्रणाम करती हूँ और मैं ये निमंत्रण देना चाहती हूँ कि कल यहाँ हम दो दिन का एक इंटरनेशनल सिंपोजियम आचार्य अभिनव गुप्त पर कर रहे हैं, जो कि कश्मीर शैव दर्शन, जिसका ओरिजिनल नाम त्रिक दर्शन है, उसके सबसे बड़े रिप्रेजेंटेटिव हैं। इनकी जो फिलॉसफी है उस पर कल से बहुत बड़े बड़े स्कॉलर्स और रिसर्चर्स आकर के बोल रहे हैं, तो तो मैं उन्हीं को सुनने के लिए आप सबको आमंत्रित करती हूँ। कृपया आप लोग को लिंक भेज दिया जाएगा, तो उसको यूज करके आइए। प्रणाम,
धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू सर, और सभी को नमस्ते। तरुण जी नमस्ते।